Test number 4 of the Phillips International Series comes to you live on Sky from Wellington's WestpacTrust Stadium as the All Blacks take on the great entertainers from Fiji. Great entertainers under a hard-nosed new coach. And you can see that the weather is not great for this match tonight as the All Blacks take a look around the ground. Tana Umanga and Leon McDonald just getting a feel of the conditions for this match tonight, which we can tell you are not very good at all. Hi everyone, and welcome to our build-up to the match tonight here at the stadium. Fiji in town, the great entertainers of world rugby, and a match that we hope will provide plenty of spectacular rugby if the conditions allow. Plenty in it for Fiji too, and that they will benefit from the proceeds for this match tonight. It's been a bit of a theme on one or two of the talkback shows this week. What is this match all about? Do we need this match? What is the point of this match? Well, to help answer that question, former All Blacks Murray Mexted and Chris Laidlaw. Chris, firstly, former coach of Fiji, what are your thoughts on the value of this match?
Well, I think it has huge value. I mean, Fiji, all the island countries are really at their wits' end. They're not making any money. They can't get gate money. They have to pay for visiting teams when they come to play there. How else are they going to make the game survive? I mean, this is something that ought to have been done 4 or 5 years ago. It's nice that it's being done now, and we need to keep doing it.
Murray.
Well, I think from a New Zealand point of view, it's very handy for John Mitchell because, I mean, it hasn't been spoken about much, but I believe he's actually still trying to work out who are his test players and who aren't his test players. I wouldn't be surprised if several members of the squad that has been picked for this series, the Phillips series to date, are dropped before the next team's announced for the tri series.
So in a way, it's a bit of a final trial for some of these players.
I think that's exactly what it is. And I think that he's had several opportunities against quite good opposition to try players out, because it's not like a provincial series or even a Super 12 series, you know. You can be a very good provincial player, but not necessarily a very good test player. And New Zealanders aren't satisfied with average test players. They want very good test players.
Well, let's have a word about conditions now, because as you've seen already, it is absolutely hosing down here in the capital. Let's go sideline. A couple of very brave men down there. They are Grant Nisbet, our match caller, and with him, Ian Smith.
Thanks very much, Tony. Yep, you're dead right. It has been raining for the best part of 2 days and still is, quite steadily too, and it's coming straight down, which suggests that there isn't a lot of breeze that we can moan about tonight in terms of Wellington weather anyway, but it is really, really wet on the outfield here. We've come to, one of the driest areas, but you can just see there, without any pressure at all, there is a lot of surface water on this park. Not the conditions that anyone would have hoped for the All Blacks trying to play free-running rugby against the champion side at that kind of game too, like Fiji, when they're at their very best. Well, Nisbo, it is disappointing. The All Whites played Dunfermline here last night. They worked overtime to get it this good, but it's going to be a big factor.
Yeah, I think if you backed Fiji giving a 61.5-point start, Smithy, you'd probably be feeling pretty happy with yourself. He has left a fair bit of grass on, and apart from underfoot conditions, which are going to be quite treacherous, I think, overhead, it's not too breezy, as you say, and it's not cold, but it's going to be difficult.
This will be hard then, I think, for us to ascertain too much out of this game, if it goes to plan, in terms of ball retention and mistakes maybe quite a dominant feature. What are Mitchell and co going to learn out of this?
Well, the All Blacks are on a bit of a hiding to nothing, because the expectations are they're going to win by plenty. So if they do, then people will say, well, they should have anyway. And if they don't, they'll be criticised. But it's an opportunity for individuals such as Cullen, who's trying to re-establish himself, such as Keller. Difficult night for halfbacks, really, in these conditions. And also, I suppose, Tane Randall as well, who's got a bit of a shot at their number 8 position. So it'd be good to watch individuals tonight, I think.
In terms of places that are pretty well cemented in the All Blacks. So there's a few blokes sitting at home with their feet up. I mean, a guy like Mertens, he won't want to get out of the dugout tonight, will he?
No, certainly. No, and there are a few. I mean, Chris Jack, obviously, and Richie McCaw. It'll be good to see Sam Harding having a run. I mean, he's probably the third number 7 in New Zealand at the moment, but a great opportunity for him.
What do you expect from Fiji? Are they nuisance value here? They've had a bit of a tough time even in their World Cup build-up themselves.
They'll be better than they were in 97. Talking to Greg Smith earlier in the week, they were intimidated by the All Blacks in 97. There's a lot of experience in this side. Players have come in from overseas, so I expect that they'll be pretty competitive for a lot of the game.
One of the other issues, of course, 2 weeks ago, Keith Wood called the yellow ball a lemon, and what he called a bar of soap as well. That will be, I think, a big issue tonight.
Well, yes, and exactly. Well, they sent the balls away overseas, didn't they? And it'll be a big test for it tonight because it's every bit the way it was in Dunedin, and it's going to be a big test for the ball. You're right.
Okay, Tony, well, that's basically it from down here. It's really, really wet. We're not talking Eden Park all those years back with that brilliant VG Williams try against Scotland. I don't think we're talking that kind of wetness. There will be areas of the ground, I think, that will be exposed. We'll be quite surprised at the water that's shown up. But it's damp all right, and it doesn't look like letting up, and pretty unpleasant, but we'll soldier on.
As you always do, Smithy, yes. And let's hope the crowd does turn out. Remember, if they get a crowd of about 25,000 here tonight, Fiji Rugby will benefit by about $150,000. As for the All Blacks, well, last week the second half against Ireland provided us with the most satisfying viewing so far this season from John Mitchell's All Blacks. They certainly stepped things up in that second 40 against the Irish on their way to a 48 win against a side that had come oh so close to causing an upset in Dunedin the week before.
Eden Park in Auckland, one of this country's premier rugby grounds, is packed out tonight as the All Blacks and Ireland prepare to do battle for the second time in 7 days. Ireland came close last week, but after 16 test matches, they still haven't recorded a win over the All Blacks, with games going back to 1905. Andrew Merton's first opportunity tonight to land the points. The All Blacks have the lead.
Well, that's the sixth phase. Ireland stringing it together.
Here's another drop kick from O'Driscoll, and he's done it again. Same as last week.
Ruben Thorne again. He's been used a couple of times tonight. With about 7.5 minutes to go in the first half, Somerville bashing his way downfield. Good burst by Greg Somerville. Now they've got some momentum. Marshall had to delay the pass. There was somebody in the road, but now it's a chance for Major. Linking up with McDonald, and Leon McDonald will score the first try of the game. A bit of magic from Aaron Major. Now it's gone wide. First time it's gone right through, and here's an opportunity for Murphy. And it took a tackle from behind by Major to sniff it out. And they've still got an opportunity here with Hayes. 5 metres short. Stringer. O'Gara, O'Driscoll. O'Driscoll close. Ball is near the line, but it's not over yet.
Well, the closest Ireland to be in scoring in both tests, in my opinion.
A crack at the line. It's a try to Longwall.
I think Robertson's been a lot better at the base of the scrum.
Toller. Toller straight through. Big moment for Marty Homer.
Well, once again, the impact player makes his mark. Marty Homer over the moon, I would say.
All Black forwards have run well tonight. Holler's shining immediately. And Howland has to reach back. And McDonald.
McDonald picks up his try tonight as the All Blacks start to run riot towards the end of the game and out to 38-8. 40 points to 8. The All Blacks have come back emphatically in the second test as Ireland look to finish with a flourish. Here's Bishop. Bishop getting close to the line. Referee looks down and he hasn't quite made it.
Lost it.
And he lost it.
Lost it forward by Green.
And that might be the end of the game.
Lost it forward.
Indeed it is, I think, yes.
Forward knocked on by Green.
All Blacks have come back at Eden Park after a scratchy performance at Carisbrook. They've hit back by scoring 5-1 and putting Ireland away by 40 points to 8.
Yes, it was much better. Conditions were not ideal last week, but certainly not even as good as that tonight here at the stadium in Wellington. You can see the players out on the field and the hardiest of the fans have arrived, but you can just see by looking at the covers there, the rain coming down on them in a big way. But there's plenty of enthusiasm, and they sold 22,000 tickets pre-sold, so hopefully they'll all turn in a few more. And we'll get that 25,000 crowd that they're hoping for. But what can they expect from the All Blacks tonight?
Murray Metzger.
Firstly, just
your thoughts on that performance last week,
particularly the second 40 minutes.
Well, I think the second 40 minutes saved series for John Mitchell, because the elimination of errors, I think, was the most important thing We went from a lot of rhythm in the Super 12 when the game was refereed differently to a test series where we made countless errors, and the New Zealand side I'm talking about, and they reduced those in the second half and allowed a little bit of a flow, a little bit of momentum to develop, and I thought they finished quite strong against what is serious
rugby opposition.
And so in some respects it was fruitful, it was beneficial, and as I said before, it certainly exposed what Mitchell wanted to look at.
A bit more aggression from the forwards, particularly in that second 40.
A lot more, yeah. But and I think they made the mistake in Dunedin of not actually preparing for the opponent they were facing. They spread the forwards, they were using forwards out wide at the breakdown. They suddenly realised that the Irish were punching through them time and time again. For that test last week, they got it right. They actually didn't. It took them a long time to get any real momentum, though, and some of the pick and go stuff was pretty slow and
laborious.
But once they did make them, they finished off very well. And in the end, you know, to score
that sort of
score against a team as good as Ireland was quite some achievement.
A different kind of test tonight, Murray, and I suppose in a
way, ideally, this game would have come before
the test against
Ireland.
Because perhaps
you're looking at
maybe a
step down in the quality of the opposition.
We're really at a
time we're
looking to build
towards the Tri Nations.
Yeah, I guess it depends on the players, the combination that he's employing, and he's obviously using different combinations. I actually thought the defensive line of the All Black team was very good against Ireland. I thought it was very good. I mean, they only scored one try, and New Zealand ended up with five in the
last
game. The Fijians, it would have been fantastic had the
sun been shining,
the ground been fast, because when you look at the Fijian side,
they've got
speed to
spin out wide and
some very, very clever players.
We've got to remember
that a lot of these players aren't based in Fiji. A lot of these players are actually overseas internationals. I think of the starting lineup, only two are based in Fiji. So
yeah,
a lot of them will have had, you know, experience of these sorts of conditions.
Guys who play in France and England.
Yeah, and you've got to also remember that it's like this in Suva a lot of it.
The rain
coming
straight down
and the ground very greasy. So a lot of these players will be very, I would have thought, you know, they've got sticky fingers too, Fijians. They picked the ball up well in the mud, so I'd give them, you know, an outside chance here.
You really would, Chris?
Well, I'm saying it's an outside. It's way outside, but it's outside.
Okay, just one word that I've written down here, which I think will be something that John Mitchell's looking for in a big way tonight, precision. This is a test of the All Blacks' ability to play precise rugby in difficult conditions.
To a game plan? I mean, without any doubt, he'd be saying, let's use this as a functional match for the tri-series. And I'm sure they'll be driving everything up front, the whole lot, trying to get some flow, trying to get some rhythm.
Andrew Mertens looks to be the happiest player on the field tonight. I wonder if that's because he's not starting in this test. Just sharing a few thoughts there with Justin Marshall.
He's like that beforehand, though. Like, every player's different before the game. Some people, I mean, he's quite flippant, actually, before the game, because his mind is not yet switched on. He's obviously the sort of guy that can switch on when he needs to.
Interesting contrast, in fact, between those two players. Normally before a test, Justin Marshall, perhaps one of the most intense players before a test.
Yes.
Andrew Mertens, one of those guys who perhaps relieves the tension by talking and chatting a lot.
It's amazing they're ever a combination, really, when you think about it. And the other two probably are not used to each other either.
They'll
so this is a big
thing,
test for them. Yeah. Well, maybe it is, and sometimes it works.
Well, if you were watching Eden Park last week, it was a huge moment for a young lad from Bay of Plenty. Now, you've seen the TV ads. Coca-Cola are providing a youngster with the chance of a lifetime, the chance to lead the All Blacks out onto the field for a test match. It was a wonderful moment for this young lad. Let's find out a little bit more about him, because he was certainly up to the task last week.
Cheers for All Blacks!
Hip, 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 hip.
My name is Brendan. I am 9 and a half. I won a New Zealand Coca-Cola competition. I've been playing rugby for 4 years and I play. My position is number 8.
Yes, good on you, Brandon. He looks like he fancies the Gilbert ball ahead of the Adidas ball, but anyway, I'm sure that it's something that he'll remember for the rest of his life. Okay, Ms. Bowe just touched on this earlier on. Look at the head start they're giving the All Blacks here. So I guess it means if you back Fiji and the All Blacks win by less than 60, you pick up a bit of money for it, $1.85. Okay, first try, Cullen Lomu Howlett all at $6.50, and Tana Umanga just behind them at $8. Fiji, well, Delisau Viliami, one of the star backs, paying $25. That's for the first try scorer in the game, I hasten to add. First try scorer, those odds. So some good money on the Fijians. Of course, it's this time of year where we are reminded of just how much rugby means to us. I guess we'll be even more aware of it in the coming weeks as we head into the Tri Nations and the Bledisloe Cup. The rich history of New Zealand rugby, and also the responsibility on the shoulders of those charged with taking our game into the future. It's just the sort of stuff to bring back a few memories. I love that shot, the old scoreboard at Athletic Park with the ad for Barter shoes on top. Everyone wore Barter shoes.
Yeah, well, you're a bit older than me, Tony, but I remember...
I beg your pardon.
The OBs, the O'Briens with the compass and the heel, mate. No, I had one of those.
O'Briens with the footy boots and the Barters. There was the Barter shoes that had the compass in them, wasn't it?
Oh, maybe I'm getting mixed up.
Is that how you used to get lost? Used to get lost on the way to school, as a Murray. Couldn't read your own compass.
Yes.
Well, John Mitchell's rotational policy continues. He's made, what, a dozen changes in this All Blacks side for the match tonight as he continues to trial out his team in preparation for the Tri Nations and the Bledisloe Cup matches ahead. They keep us guessing. Robbie Deans keeps on saying, well, you know, we've probably pick a different combination every week, but here is the 15 that John Mitchell and Robbie Deans have named for this test match here tonight against Fiji at the stadium in Wellington.
Getting a chance to prove himself in the black jersey again is fullback Christian Cullen playing in his hometown stadium. Doug Howlett impressed enough from the bench last week to win back his starting place against Fiji. Another hometown hero starts on the other wing. It's big John Olomu in number 11 again. Hurricane number 3 at home tonight is Tana Umanga, playing at centre after his starring role on the wing for the Barbars last week. He's joined in the midfield by another veteran back in the starting lineup, experienced Crusader Daryl Gibson. In his first test start in the number 10 jersey, big tackling Crusader Aaron Major takes over from Andrew Mertens. Byron Callagher scored a try in his first 30 seconds on the field against Ireland last week and gets the start this weekend. Into the engine room where former All Black skipper Tane Randall has a chance to prove himself at number 8. In his debut test, another who'll want to make a big impact tonight is another Otago man, Sam Harding. On the other side, skipper Reuben Thorne gets the run on in his first test as captain at WestpacTrust Stadium. There's no question that Norm Maxwell's laid claim to the number 5 jersey, tonight playing in his 23rd straight test. A big opportunity for another Otago forward, Simon Mayling joins Norm Maxwell at lock tonight. Into the front row, Case Mews is back in action after a couple of weeks off. His last start was against Italy. On the Loosehead side is a man who's made good progress in the black jersey, Joe McDonnell. At hooker, getting his second start of the year in a test, another Highlander, Tom Willis. On the bench, it's all Crusaders. Leon McDonald will be keeping a close eye on Christian Cullen's form, while Andrew Mertens will also no doubt be watching with interest how Aaron Major goes at number 10. A complete role reversal for Justin Marshall. He started last week while Callaghan warmed the bench. This time it's the other way round. Plenty of forward backup on the bench with Scott Robertson no doubt itching for more test time. Chris Jack's on hand to beef up the All Black locking strike power. And backing up the front rowers, it's another couple of Crusaders, Dave Hewitt, and standby hooker Mark Hammett, who performed solidly against Ireland at Eden Park last week.
Yes, big changes again, and I guess we live in changing times. I mean, there's been a school of thought throughout the years that always put the best available 15 out on the field. But in this day and age, Murray, is that practicable?
No, it's not. Absolutely not. It doesn't work like that, does it? I mean, how many times do you see 15 players starting a match and finishing a match? I mean, they're pulling them off and pulling them on all the time. And also, the other thing is that the traditional position that players play is nowhere near the same. If you're a back, you're expected to be just as good as the loose forwards at the breakdown. And all of a sudden, it's role reversal, so the whole thing's completely different.
I think the most interesting experiment tonight is Major at first five with Callaghan, because clearly that's a possibility for next year. If something happened to Mertens, Major is going to have to come in. He's been practicing up his goal kicking. They need Major. Major is now the most important person in this squad, in my view, and I do hope he has a good one tonight.
Most important person?
Yep.
Huge. Well, you know, he's got a big role tonight, hasn't he? And he's seen as a linchpin of future All Black teams. What about the blokes outside him? And we look at particular Cullen and Lomu. I mean, the heat's really on those guys to come up with the goods tonight, isn't it?
It's the million-dollar question, isn't it? I mean, we all want Chris and Cullen to really front big time, don't we? And I feel so sorry for him that the weather conditions are like they are, and he's not going to get that opportunity that he probably deserves. I mean, who knows, they might play sublime rugby in wet conditions, but they have to be very accurate and very precise to do so, and it makes it harder tonight.
Let's just hope the first pass to Jonah is a good one, because if he does get a good ball and he does get some momentum, he tends to play very well.
So often it's important to get him involved early on in the game. What about some of the forwards, a guy like Case Mews? Now, here's a player who had a pretty good season with the Blues in Super 12. He's a big man. He's able to advance the ball. He's the sort of player that John Mitchell really wants to be playing well, doesn't he?
Well, I think that's why he's in the squad. I mean, physically, he's bigger than Somerville, and I think that everybody's very comfortable with Somerville as our number one tight head. But every now and again, you need more physique on the field in certain matches, and I think he gives that option if he's good enough and if he's consistently good enough. And I guess that's what Mitchell wants to find out.
He's a bit like a bottle of home brew. He's been brewed up, and kept in waiting. Now he's about to explode, and I think this is going to be his big night.
Explode what, and then call it a day afterwards?
No. Well, he won't explode.
Well, a lot can happen in a week, can't it? I mean, this time last week, Christian Cullen was just kicking back after having played a club game in the afternoon. He wasn't wanted by the All Blacks, and so he came back. He played club football here, and now here he is back in front of his home fans, playing in the test against Fiji. As we've just mentioned, it is a very big opportunity for Christian Cullen to try and win back his place in the first choice All Black starting 15. So it's a choice that he is, or a chance I should say, that he is intending to make the most of.
He's got support, he won't need it. And a brilliant try, scored by a brilliant player.
Yeah, fair day, I guess. Couple weeks off, so we play club footy, so yeah, that is good to get back, and especially for, you know, a home game. Yeah, I actually really enjoyed it. It's been 5 years since I, you know, played a club game, so it was good to finally get there, and you know, we had a good win, and you know, I think the boys, you know, second place in the top eight, so which was good.
Here comes Cullen again, injecting his great pace.
Well, I mean, obviously it wasn't, I don't think it was that great during the Super 12, but I think they, as a team, we struggled, so, you know, a bit harder. But I think, you know, coming into an environment now, and obviously I've only played one game, so, you know, I was pretty happy with, you know, what I did in that game, and, you know, it's getting better.
Can they get it wider quickly?
Yeah, it'll be good to run out of them and know that they're there, and yeah, it'll be a good good night for us to run out on the stadium.
Fiji backs, Satala, always a threat. Funimbaka going for the corner.
I mean, obviously, probably a lot different to Ireland, and you know, they probably like to throw the ball around a bit more, and you know, pretty skillful players. So you know, hopefully, we can starve them of ball and you know, hold on to the ball, you know, mostly ourselves and run at them.
It was an interesting call by John Mitchell. The word that got out was that he'd been told to go play club rugby and work on his communication.
Yes. He's been given a very hard time in the last few weeks, and he's not a great communicator. He's just a natural player. He needs to be melded into the squad. You can't ask him to call the plays. I mean, he does it naturally. And it's the players around him that have got to create the opportunities for Christian Cullen. When they do, he's brilliant.
It's a sign, though, that Robbie Deans and John Mitchell want a very patterned approach to their play, want it well organised, and just a suggestion that maybe they don't think that Christian Cullen quite fits into that at the moment.
Oh, I don't know about that. Surely they can't think that. Just a quick aside, Tony, I believe that the first training session that Christian Cullen went to for Norths at the club side he plays for in Wellington, he went along and it was raining so hard the ground was closed. So they trained on the local car park. They had to run down to the shopping centre and train in the car park on Tarsil and run all the way back. Now that would have been a big change for Christian Cullen and Peter Alatini too, I might add.
Well, let's hope he has a big one tonight, Christian Cullen, because when he's playing well, there are a few better sights in rugby. Well, there's some very hardy fans have got here early to the stadium tonight, and they're downstairs now with Ian Smith.
Yeah, thanks, Tony. Well, I'm sitting with a couple of buddies here. Tony and Lucy have travelled all the way down from the Manawatu Dairy Farmers. We're sitting in the players' dugout because they've got a bit of protection tonight from the rain. Also, it's lit up a wee bit at the moment. We're staring out at the ground because absolutely nothing is going on at the moment. Curtain raiser was cancelled due to the weather and the entertainment hasn't started yet. So why not get an opinion of people in the street about the All Blacks and where they're at the moment. Tony, what are they saying in your neck of the woods? We're only 2 weeks away from Australia, aren't we?
Yeah, well, it is only 2 weeks, and yeah, hopefully we can see a bit better performance from them, because yeah, I wouldn't like to see them going to Australia at the moment. But you know, yeah, 2 weeks is 2 weeks. Anything could happen.
What's the problem area for you? Too many mistakes, you think?
Yeah, just too many basic mistakes. You know, just at the end of the day, it is a basic game, and if they can play the basics, they'll win.
Lucy, have you come here tonight expecting a big performance from?
Oh well, obviously, I think we'd like to see Jonah have a big game. And yeah, but I mean, also I'd like to see Reuben Thorne.
You're a bit of a Reuben Thorne fan. What was that?
Oh, I just think he's got a good attitude. I think, you know, he'll be a good All Black captain. I think he's showing that he'll get it together and yeah, really stand by the boys. So yeah,
I'm going to put it on you, Tony. Now, if you were picking the halfback, okay, who's your halfback at the moment?
I think I'll go with Byron Kelleher at the moment. Yeah.
What about you think Cullen's got a sniff at fullback?
I think he has, yeah, if he can come out tonight and hold on to the ball and have a good game. Yeah.
Okay, well, it's good tonight. It's just a general feeling in the street, isn't it, really? I think we'd like a big performance, but we're just a little worried, I think.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Just a little worried, yeah, we'd like to see a good performance.
Okay, well, you go back up to your cushy little season tickets and think of me down here in the rain, won't you?
Oh, will do. Will do.
Cheers, all the best, thanks.
Well, I notice it hasn't taken too long for Smithy to be sitting down on the job. You can see they're all kitted up for the wet weather here tonight. Don't forget that after this test match tonight, we're going to Australia for the second test between the Wallabies and France. Much stronger looking French team for this match tonight. And looking forward to seeing how they go after the Aussies got up and won the first test at Colonial Stadium last week. So that's the second test between the Wallabies and France coming up straight after our coverage from WestpacTrust Stadium here tonight. Well, the All Blacks opponent this week, I guess it's couldn't be much more different from what we saw last week against the Irish, of course. A traditional team, a strong Six Nations team, a team full of forward grunt and it played exactly how we thought they would. Up against them, of course, Fiji. They've been the great entertainers of world rugby, although in recent years it's really been the seven-a-side game which has taken precedence in Fiji, despite the efforts of the likes of Brad Johnston and Greg Smith to change that around. Mac McCallion is the man now charged with restoring perhaps the fortunes of Fiji in 15-a-side rugby. They're about a step away from qualifying for the Rugby World Cup, and they will be hoping to gear up for the rest of their qualifying campaign with a win here tonight. The Fijian side under the leadership of Mac McCallion and Greg Smith.
A
And the All Blacks have started their international season with a victory here at the North Harbour Stadium tonight by 71 points to 5.
The team that played here in 97 was a young team. It was my first test as a captain. It was for these boys. It was some of their first test matches. One of our key men, Simon Rorolui, was his first test match, and now he's a captain in Newport and experienced, very experienced. Mickey Little was just still a kid. Now he's growing up. So we're an older team. We've been through a World Cup campaign together. We've got a mix of young guys, but certainly a mix of old heads that have played a lot of international rugby and have been around for a while.
I know when they played them the last time in Albany, they were absolutely just in awe of the black jersey and playing against the All Blacks. But I certainly don't want to put any pressure on these guys, because if you put pressure on them, they don't perform. So I'm trying to get them to say, hey, we're just playing another team. Whether it works or not is another story, but we want to keep it low key at this point.
And here is Saradaki pushing it ahead. Michael Jones is the only player back.
It's important because we must take the opportunity that's given to us, because, as I say, 97 was the last time we were given the chance, and so we have to take the chance that's there. So it's an opportunity to measure our progress since that time. And also it gives the guys that aren't experienced as the others a chance to play against the best, I guess. And we grew as a team as a result of the loss we had that night in 97, and I'm sure the boys that this is their first time, they'll also grow from the experience on Saturday.
We've got to come out of this game with some credibility, and we're coming down here, we're going to have a fair crack at them. We want to play the rugby, the style that we're used to, and we want to attack. That's what we're aiming to do, and hopefully come away with some points.
After a scratchy performance at Carisbrook, they've hit back tonight by scoring 5-1. And putting Ireland away by 40 points to 8.
We need to get a bit more structure in our game, especially at scrum time, and that's a vital part of the game nowadays, believe it or not. We've got a pretty good back line, and I think the back line could match any back line in the world today, but if you can't give them go forward ball, they will struggle.
Oh, it's a mental hurdle surely for us, because the boys grow up in Fiji looking at the All Blacks, and that's all people talk about. And if you go to Fiji, I think the people in Fiji know more about the All Blacks than maybe New Zealanders do, So certainly there's that element there, but we have to take care of that with what we do during the week, and make them realise that just because they're wearing black jerseys, they're no different than us, It's just, they're still men.
At the moment, though, it's Fiji who've been delighting the crowd. Now, this man really would deserve a try. Now, Tomba has been brilliant this afternoon.
New Zealanders are just seeing now that what Fijians can do in the Super 12 and the preparation that Fijians are given as part of Super 12 teams, just how good they can be. And this is a unit that has the potential to be very, very good if given the chance, and helped out with a bit of finance and given an even playing field to compete with the likes of the All Blacks.
Crowd being entertained now by the Wellington High whānau Atara Ika after fairly good display by the Fijian youth of Wellington. So the young people, the Maori culture, the Fijian culture on display here tonight. There are the young Fijians who've just put on a really good display. Now the Wellington High whānau Atara Ika. Meanwhile, the All Blacks are warming up in their dressing room. We'll go into the dressing room in just a moment. And here's Christian Cullen. What a night for him. In front of the home fans. Very important night in his career, one would imagine. Of course, really one of the focal points of the international season coming up. It is the battle for the Tri Nations and with it the Bledisloe Cup. July the 13th, Black Saturday. Put it in the books. It's the day we take on the Wallabies in Christchurch, and on the Rugby Channel, free to digital subscribers between 8 a.m. and midnight. All sorts of features leading up to and after the game. All Black archives, special profiles. We'll have reports throughout the day from Christchurch, and of course live test coverage in widescreen. So that's something to look forward to, free to digital subscribers on Black Saturday here on Sky and on our special rugby channel. Well, we're building up to kickoff in this test match between the All Blacks and Fiji here at the stadium in Wellington. And one of the features of our test match build-up is that we're able to take you inside the All Black changing room as the All Blacks get the word from tonight's referee, Australia's Scott Young. The All Blacks, even the All Blacks have to get their sprigs checked. Happens from the very early days, doesn't it? See Peter Marshall there, just having a chat.
It's nice to see this sort of fraternisation, isn't it? It eases the tension beforehand. It's good to see it.
It's a pretty personal time though, this time before a test match, Tony. There's a lot of different ways of being ready in the zone when you take the field.
Here's Scott Young now talking to the All Black forwards.
Stand up, I'm going to call that engage ball and free kick against you straight away. Okay. Any questions? Yep. I'll keep this clear. But I will, once that engage ball, I'll allow the chance for that. Just have to allow it from there.
Yes, the coaches have their say early on the week. They have a chat with the refs, and that special time there with the referee and the players just talking through the sorts of things that he's going to be looking for during the game, and just helping everyone to get on the same wavelength, which is so important when it comes to producing an interesting and exciting flowing spectacle of rugby. Let's hope we're going to see that tonight here at the stadium. Well, there's been talk during the week about the importance of this test match, but as we've already discussed, really for some players it is an extremely important match. It is a test match, of course, the All Blacks against Fiji. Any test is important, but as the Tri Nations, the Bledisloe Cup approaches, so important for some of the players getting the opportunity tonight to stake their claim. A couple of young players who that applies to, Simon Mayling, who of course came into the All Black side right at the end of last year, and another young Highlanders player who makes the step up tonight, a huge night for young flanker Sam Harding.
Harlich is leading the charge, looking for a good bounce, and oh, beautifully snapped up, and here's a try for Sam Harding.
Honestly, couldn't really remember what sort of was going on in that game. It was sort of a quite a free, loose game, so it's quite tough to work out how you've done in a game like that.
Also, test debuts in the pack for two other Otago players, Simon Mayling and Tom Willis.
That game, I had a little bit more than normal, which is understandable, but it sort of took a while to get over those nerves, but once they went, it sort of wasn't too bad.
Well, at the moment, I'm telling myself I'm going to be calm and relaxed, but I think come Saturday it might be a bit of a different story, but no, hopefully I can keep it under control.
Normally, as I say, in Super 12, whatever, you're out of the shed and pretty much into it, so there's a little bit of downtime before the game, so you just got to handle that. But it's a bit of fun getting out of there, trying to sing the anthem and do the huck.
So Mayling, a new face in the All Black test team.
But nicely too, Simon Mayling. Now they're going to have a go at the line here, the All Blacks. Held up by the Italians for the moment. The try is scored. I think it's Joe McDonnell.
Yeah, I think it was.
It is Joe McDonnell. Good on you, Joe.
Yeah, grafter. It's interesting. I've sort of been labelled the grafter by numerous in the media. I like to think of myself as a bit of a ball player, Grant, so I'll have to change that. But, yeah, just get out there and do my normal thing, try and win a bit of ball in the lineouts and what have you, and just work around the field. And if other things come, then okay. No, you got to do your job first and foremost, and then you get to have a bit of a run around and do the odd thing, and that's good. But it's just do your job first, and then go from there.
Mariko Vurumbaka, pace, power, strength, and a beautiful try.
knowing a few of the Fijian boys I've played with, they'll be flying into it, and if we give them too many scraps, then they'll make for a very difficult 80 minutes.
I imagine they're going to be rather tough. Fijians always seem to be quite bony, and when you try and tackle them, they seem to hurt you. But no, I think they'll probably run it at us wherever they can, and it'll be interesting to see how they do go.
There he is, Sam Harding. He's looked to have a big future in front of him ever since he started playing at Colts level for New Zealand, and John Mitchell has put his faith in the young man tonight. Norm Maxwell, of course, such a key man in the lineouts, and Simon Mayling, a man who, well, I guess does the simple things well at lineout time, Murray.
They say he's extremely organised, that he calls the lineouts for the Highlanders, who had great success, if you recall, in the Super 12. Their accuracy and their success rate was huge. So I'm sure that's one of the reasons he's in this team. That was an area we had problem with last year. So, and he didn't quite achieve that in the first test, you'll recall, against Ireland. Perhaps tonight, because the pressure will be on tonight.
Well, there's a lot of interest in how this man performs tonight. Robin Brook was saying on reunion this week, Chris, that he felt Jonah perhaps didn't go looking for enough work last week.
Yeah, it's been a perennial problem for Jonah. He's often tended to get lost, to get isolated, not to be sure where he's supposed to be. He tends to drift a bit, but when he's focused, and he has, particularly when he has Tana with him, he is much more focused. Tana's a very important figure.
Well, we haven't talked about Tana, have we? But here's a guy who showed last week in that Barbarians match against the New Zealand Māori just how much he wants to be part of this team. That was a fantastic performance.
Yeah, and there's no shortage of work rate with Tana, Umanga. In fact, his work rate is huge. I mean, it's particularly on the tackle and recovery of the ball area, I think, is magnificent. And the other thing that he's so strong, and he's proven it time and time again, when he gets the ball in an all-black back line, it throws the opposition defence into disarray, and that's got to be good.
But there's absolutely no reason why Tana isn't going to be part of this all the way through. When Robinson was put in last week, I think, specifically to try him out against the best centre in the world, the best running centre, O'Driscoll.
How'd he go?
He came through all right, I thought. Well, O'Driscoll never got through him.
Yeah.
But Tana's back in again, and Tana is an organiser. He's a very, very good player.
Let's get a word now on the conditions. Has it improved at all, Smithy?
Well, Tony, I'd have to say that it's lightened up a wee bit in terms of the rain, but it's still be very, very greasy on top. Just watching the All Blacks go through their little routines next to me, and the key to it has been they've been doing it all at pace, and the ball retention and the exercise routines has been very good. So they make their way back to the dressing room, they'll know it's going to be a totally different situation about a quarter of an hour, because they're going to have some defence in their face and some very aggressive defence. Yeah, good points about Jonah Lomu. He won't have any excuses tonight, maybe apart from the weather. He's surrounded by mates. He'll be back on the left wing, not on that right wing position they've been trialling him at. So I would imagine, like a lot of people here, we're expecting a big performance from Jonah Lomu. Unbelievably, though, and unusually too in modern times, have not seen the Fijians at all. One or two of them just came out, poked and prodded the playing surface just to see just how damp it was, but they have not done any exercises that I can see out and about. So Mac McCallion, sturdy old Mac McCallion, the adversary of John Mitchell there, has kept them under wraps, and he'll be talking very sternly to them. Yep, I can say it's probably a bit lighter in terms of the rain, but it's going to be really wet, Tony, and holding on to that yellow thing is going to be the issue again.
Okay, well, some final thoughts there from Ian Smith's sideline. Let's get final thoughts now before we go to our commentary team. Murray Mexted, the All Blacks tonight, what are you looking for?
Well, I'm looking for complete control up front, total accuracy and discipline, retention of possession.
Chris Laidlaw.
It's play hide the ball tonight. The Fijians must not be given the ball in the open field. And if this is a very good experiment for the All Blacks. This is an ideal way of proving a number of the players in this squad.
Okay, coming up live from the stadium in Wellington, it's a night to test the hardiest of fans, and it's a night to test also the precision play of the All Blacks up against Fiji in this test match, which all the proceeds, the profits, are going to Fiji and rugby. Stand by for kickoff when we come back between the All Blacks and Fiji at WestpacTrust Stadium here in Wellington.
The All Blacks versus Fiji is proudly brought to you by Telecom New Zealand. In partnership with Ford New Zealand.
Pacific Island rugby has been somewhat neglected in recent seasons, but this evening it's very much in focus as Fiji comes to Wellington and will leave with all the proceeds from tonight's match. The Fijians, under New Zealand coach Mac McCallion, are currently in the middle of qualifying for next year's World Cup, but they've come to New Zealand to face an all-black team which is building towards the start of the Tri Nations in 2 weeks' time. Well, weather conditions in the capital really couldn't be much worse. It's been raining in Wellington all day. It's still raining. And underfoot conditions here at the WestpacTrust Stadium will be treacherous. There's no wind to speak of. It certainly isn't cold, but the rain continues to fall in the capital city as we go into the Fijian dressing room as they prepare for their third ever test match against the All Blacks. In previous games, they've been beaten by 74-13 back in 1987, 71-5 in 1990. ...of... probably just over 20,000. They said that they'd sold 22,000 seats for this game. One would imagine that some people have paid and not bothered to turn up because of the conditions. But as is normal these days, the crowd really starting to assemble now in the couple of minutes before kickoff. Let's welcome our international audience tonight. And as usual, Fox Sport and Channel 7 in Australia, B Sky B in Britain, Super Sport through Mnet in South Africa, Star Sport throughout Asia, Fox Sports World in North America, and special welcome to the New Zealand cricket team. They'll see this game, I'm sure, probably off tape, but a pretty good day's play. First day of the second test for the New Zealand cricket team, and also, of course, Sky Sport in New Zealand, the Pacific Islands, and we welcome our Fijian viewers in particular, and of course, as we always do, our friends in the Chatham Islands as well. So a huge international audience for this test match between the All Blacks and Fiji, being played or will be played in conditions not particularly conducive to running rugby tonight. And it will be interesting just to see how it unfolds. Curtain raiser was taken away from the ground to preserve the surface, and the wicket block area was covered for most of the afternoon and early evening. So we await the arrival of the Fijian side. Quick opportunity to go sideline to Smithy and tell us about those conditions for the international audience. Smithy.
Yes, good evening, Nisbo, and all those folks looking on. You're dead right. It has been raining for 48 hours, really on and off. They played the soccer international here, the All Whites versus Dunfermline, was pretty good for that. But it will be greasy, as you say, and parts of this ground will be particularly awash. So look out for that. Ball retention, the little yellow thing, Nisbo, that could be the issue. Who can control it the best?
So here they come, the Fijians onto WestpacTrust Stadium for the first time. It's a big Fijian forward pack that has undergone some changes from the team that played Manu Soma last week. Big Bill Thabambati, a real Wellington favourite, certainly adds bulk to the front row, but his preparation for this has only been a dose of club rugby, and captain Greg Smith will take his place in the Fijian pack. Nicky Little has scored more test points, 484, than any other Fijian player. And on a night like tonight, his tactical kicking will be vital. There is some exciting talent out wide with the likes of Dalasau and Satala, but sadly, conditions may be against those key players. John Mitchell and Robbie Deans have said all they're going to say. And it's now up to the All Blacks, and you can see that the stand in the background there noticeably filling late as people pour into the ground. And now Reuben Thorne and the All Blacks. Third in line to wear the number. number 7 All Black jersey, but tonight is a huge night for Otago's Sam Harding as he makes his international debut. Harding has won a number of changes from last week with Tane Randall, Simon Mayling, Case Muse, Tom Willis and Joe McDonnell all back in the starting 15. And after a much publicised club rugby match last week, Christian Cullen returns to fullback for the All Blacks, player's 54th test. A couple of tries tonight will see Cullen become the All Blacks' greatest try scorer, but that won't be on his mind as he tries to regain the number one spot from Leon McDonald.
Every weekend in New Zealand during winter, hundreds of thousands of players, coaches, referees and volunteers are involved in the game of rugby. In the last couple of weeks, two of those people, the referee and the player, tragically died while participating.
They're standing by now for a minute's silence in memory of two rugby identities who passed away in the last 10 days or so, Stephen Takiwa and Tina Amato. And now we come to the national anthems and the Fijian national anthem to be sung by the Fijian Youth of Wellington Choir.
The anthems to be sung by the Fijian Youth Choir and the Wellington East Girls Choir.
beautifully presented. Firstly, the Fijian Youth of Wellington Choir, then the Wellington East Girls College Choir. Now the haka and the thimbi. Let's see if they coincide with each other. Often they do. With me tonight, and Murray, that was terrific.
Oh, it just adds a bit of emotion to the whole thing, doesn't it? It sets the stage, it brings both teams together. The Thimbi, she's a fairly active sort of rendition, isn't it?
Just want to check with the
Scott Young of Australia, the referee tonight here in Wellington, with Peter Marshall and Greg Hinton, also from Australia. George Ibe to look after the video referee duties. And we're almost set to go. Crowd building up nicely.
You right to go?
Getting close towards 25,000, one would imagine, as the rain continues to fall.
You right? Ruben?
Scott Young checking with everyone. Okay, and we're almost set to go. Nikki Little with the ball. And the third ever test match between the All Blacks and Fiji is underway. And he goes along the ground, which was a good move.
It's a ruck. Stay on side here.
The ball is going to get greasy fairly quickly. Kelleher is kicking from the base. Immediately down to number 8 for Dovi Virata. And here goes fullback Ulianeu. They're going to open it up early here, and they've got some space too, the Fijians. They're exciting when they run with the ball. And it's 15 out from the 22. Comes to Raluni. And a kick in behind the All Blacks. Howlett having to get back, and he's done extremely well and called for the mark too.
Outstanding skills. Doug Howlett, the speed that he turned at and sprinted backwards. Magnificent. And then marked the ball when he was in mid-air. Have a look at this here. Well, he wasn't quite in mid-air, but he was certainly running. The hardest catch in the business is running backwards, catching the ball over your head.
First throw of the day by Willis, tipped on the All Black side with difficulty, but they did manage it, and that's the 10-metre line, All Black territory. Now it's Tom Willis, and there'll be some big tackling first up for sure, as Aaron Major, who's slotting in at first 5'8 tonight, remember, Ulianeu, the fullback for the Fijians. Oh, there's some wide open spaces here. And Cullen having to race across. And what a terrific kick that was. There was a yawning gap down the All Black right wing side. And it was exploited by Alfred Ulianeu.
Yeah, the gap shouldn't have been there. Great start to Fiji. Great start. Well, that kick went through, and of course, Howlett followed it up. And there was nobody filling that hole back there. So that's Aaron Major, desperate to get back.
Greg Smith with a throw. Here's a charge for the Fijians. Very close to the line. Raluni is going to get it eventually. It's coming rather slowly. It's almost over the line. And in fact, Scott Young says, let's go back 5 metres. That was a near thing. And the All Blacks under pressure early here.
Well, great start, Fiji. The first kickoff, it was on the deck. They were thinking about it, obviously, beforehand. Makes it hard for the All Blacks right from the start. Then they moved it, and now the heat goes on. How's the scrum? The scrum's good.
Now Looney feeds it off to Nicky Little. Harding had to make a tackle there. There's the All Black goal line. It's exposed. Now they have another go at the line. It's a desperate defence here from the All Blacks. Ball pops out. Referee playing advantage. And there's going to be a penalty.
Over here.
Well, they want to take it quickly, but I would think that wiser heads may prevail here. And Greg Smith will say, hang on, let's grab the 3 points while we can.
Well, he'd have to, wouldn't he? Because that's Jacob Raluni. Everyone will remember that name from the Reds, the Queensland Reds. Now, he has scored tries in Super 12 just exactly in that situation this season. The quick tap. Well, this is great defence, but also great attack. Really concerted attack here. Difficult to stop too on such a wet ground, because if you hit the deck short of the line, the momentum, if there is momentum, will often take a player over the goal line.
So the first points have come up, and it's a penalty goal kicked by Nicky Little for the Fijians, and they have the lead by 3 points to nil.
Great Let's start, Fiji.
Totally different build-ups in the last 20 for these teams. The All Blacks out and about with their fancy little teamwork drills. The Fijians not sighted, so Mac McCallion, whatever he said, it worked.
Raluni with the kick down towards Jonah Lomu's wing, and good clearance. They've started very well. This is a very much different team Fiji are fielding this year. 1997, Greg Smith, they were intimidated by the All Blacks, but there's too much experience in this Fijian side to be intimidated. A lot of these players, high percentage of them, play their rugby in the Northern Hemisphere. Tom Willis, well claimed by Simon Mayling, and the All Blacks will just want to get a feel of the ball and control it, 5 metres on their own side of halfway.
Well, that looks like that'll be the tune for the day. The drive from the line out, I'm absolutely sure. They'll only want ball going forward against these guys.
Gallagher's kick will come down near the 10-metre line. Again, it's loose, but it's been nicely snapped up in there by Ulianeu once again. Now Little looking to shift. If they've got extreme pace, we know that. But a lovely tackle by Umanga on his opposite number, Satala. There's plenty of hands going on in there. But the All Blacks lost control of that. And away goes Raluni once more. Now Smith gets hit hard in midfield by a combination of the two lock forwards, Maxwell and Mayling. Little flicks it back on the inside to Rambini. And he lost it forward, or he passed it forward in actual fact. But they've certainly had more ball than the All Blacks.
Oh, great defence, Tanu. A copybook tackle for all the young men watching this. And straight away, have a look, he's up on his feet.
Stand up, please. Ball's the other side.
Well, we saw a bit of sleight of hand of the Fijian sides there, I guess. Look at that weight advantage to Fiji.
Stay bound.
Randall off the back for Kelleher. Here's Cullen chiming in. Lovely sidestep. Couldn't get away, though. Now it's Reuben Thorne, the skipper, as the All Blacks try to get something going. Major shovels out in midfield to Lomu, who's in there looking for some work. And he got rid of the first man earlier. And I think it was Greg Smith who went down in a heap, as Major moves it on for Gibson. Umanga is out lurking on the left wing side. The All Blacks, so that's offside. It's a mile offside. Fijian player. And the referee will play some advantage here. There's got to be another one. So I'll take the original. Player coming in from the wrong angle. And it'll be a penalty to the All Blacks.
So Christian Cullen, the first time he receives the ball. Off his right. Well held by Little. The great support, Reuben Thorne, right where he should have been, directly behind, which means whatever way Cullen goes, he'll be in support.
Very nice to see Murray, Christian Cullen, stepping off that leg. That's a very good sign. He obviously wanted to try it early, and it looks to be good.
Chris Laidlaw, our match analyst tonight. And here's Aaron Major.
Oh, still white.
He's taken over the goal-kicking duties in the absence tonight of Andrew Mertens. Mertens on the bench. Pretty tough one first up. Got it up nice and high, and that is a real confidence booster for Aaron Major, and it's 3-3.
Ah, distinct smile I see on Aaron Major's face. Well, what a way to start. 40-metre penalty right near the touchline angle. Well, Andrew Merton's quite pleased with it also.
Well, the man who scored 848 test points, he knows how it's done. Simon Mayling. Well, they've gone along the ground twice with drop kicks tonight, and that's a very good tactic in these conditions. Ulianeau has to get across. Plays his rugby in Japan these days, having previously played in Auckland. Cullen. And he makes the clearance, Christian Cullen. 54th test match tonight for Christian Cullen. Played club rugby last week, of course. poised on 43 test tries. So tonight, everything goes according to plan. A little bit of history could be created by Christian Cullen. Tipped on the Fijian side by Koyamaboli. That's the 10-metre line, All Black territory, Raluni. Here's the call from Richard Nyholt, who's the loose head prop. Doing a little more kicking than you'd normally expect, but that's the story in these conditions. Howlett is well held by Zalasau. And here's Case Mews, who's done a great job to get back in defence. Referee's playing advantage, and he may decide that there's no advantage so far. And he goes back for offside against Fiji.
Well, Mews was back in support. Fantastic, really. In fact, he drove around the short side. Was it Mews or McDonnell? Drove around the short side, and there was nobody there, not even a supporting player. Let's have a look at it. Well, it's certainly Case Mews. No one there. Pete Raluni set it up, and for a moment there I thought the support was a bit slow, and then two arrived right over the top. Well, welcome back to the fray, Case Mews.
Big job tonight for Case Mews after Greg Somerville's performance last week in the second test against Ireland. Tom Willis. Let's look the straightest of lines through the middle of that line-out. Well claimed in there by Reuben Thorne. They used him a lot at number two in the line-out last week. There it is for Byron Keller. He's having a little bit of a dream. The ball is on the ground. Now Major gives it off to Umaga. Slips a beautiful pass. And away goes Cullen. Christian Cullen. That equals Jeff Wilson's record.
Well, the crowd love it. I love it. I saw a great try here scored by the All Blacks right here at this stadium in the Blitters Road Cup a couple of years ago. But that one there, I really loved. Have a look in the replay of the timing. This was magnificent. Umanga took them on, beat them up, loaded, and Howlett with the speed, drew the fullback. Well, that try would have been scored against any opposition anywhere. That was magnificent timing. Threw in just enough power to get the pass away, and Howlett did everything right. Like last week, Howlett drew the last man and fed the pass right at the right time. Well, Christian Cullen would be delighted.
44th test try for the All Blacks, 50th try, but 44 takes them to Jeff Wilson's All Black record. And now Aaron Major. He's wide, but really this was absolute precision. The offload from Umanga and the draw and pass by Doug Howlett, and Christian Cullen, who knows better than most the way to the try line. So the All Blacks have an 8-3 lead. Little this time goes to the air. Kelleher wants it. Randall had to stretch for the pass, but dragged it in nicely. Now Major drops back deep and makes a good clearance down towards the halfway line. Well, he's a talented player, Aaron Major, and he can slot in at first 5-8, as he's shown many times.
Looks to me like Kelleher's been told to spin nothing that's going backwards, maybe even stationary. The last ruck we saw, he wasn't happy that the ball was stationary.
Smith with a good throw gets it back. Now the charge comes from Siwambu for Fiji, the open side flanker. Not afraid to use the ball. And a good tackle by Tom Willis. Now it's been stolen.
Beautifully stolen too.
As they set a light, Gibson heaves it out into centre field. Major stabs it through. Lomu's coming quickly.
Now that turnover was forced by Case Mews. Jeez, he's getting around the paddock very early on in the game. I think we should compliment both sides in this, Bo. This is not the best of conditions, but the ball handling, some of the passing, very crisp, outstanding rugby.
Well, tremendous support by Mews. It was left on a platter for him, I will say, but he had to be there, and he was.
Greg Smith under a lot of doubt prior to this match because of a toe injury as the All Blacks steal one at line-out time. Gibson gets it wide out to Howlett. He's got blinding speed, Doug Howlett. Now the kick and chase. Oh, that's super. That is quite outstanding from Doug Howlett.
Well, Tana Umanga recognises a piece of brilliance it was, because look at the way he stood up his opposite winger. Just have a little look at that. Unbelievable, really. And it's Dallas out too. It was a great football. He stood him flat. Bad pass. Almost stationary. Into him, and then it's inside, outside. See you later. Chip kick. Plenty of speed, plenty of timing, plenty of skill.
Lisbo, haven't the All Black selectors been mucking around with this number 14 jersey? They've had Lomu out there, they've tried Howlett, they haven't given him a full game. Maybe we've just solved the problem there.
That's the advantage of getting the ball late. Doug Howlett got it late, and he was able to stand and then accelerate outside his man, but brought bad tackling by the Fijian winger.
Catch the wink, Mum. Did you see that one?
Aaron Major comes across to this near side for his... for a crack at the conversion, and he can't bring it around. So a couple of unconverted tries. Doug Howlett comes up with his 12th test try and just his 16th international, and that was outstanding individual brilliance.
Kick back.
Bit slow to start the All Blacks, but they've thrown it into another gear now with the Cullen and the Howlett tries. Little, I think he might have kicked it too far. No, not quite. Kelleher almost had his foot on the line as Randall takes it up.
It's a ruck. Stay on it. That's all right. It's a ruck there. Leave it.
And Kelleher doing quite a bit of kicking from the base.
Yeah, once again, you see stationary ball. So he's not passing it at all. He's kicking it over top if he has to get stationary, or he's telling them to keep it going. Keep it going. Try to get the forward momentum.
Smith goes deep with this throw. Nice hands by Niholt again. And the prop forward takes it up. And Sam Harding is offside. It's that grey area. The player's not sure whether it's a ruck. Some referees will say it's a ruck. Others remain silent and just penalise you anyway.
That's a tough call, really. That ball was out.
Well, yeah, it was out.
And he came from the back.
So there's Sam Harding. He certainly has an international pedigree. His great uncle, Roe Harding, played for Wales.
Still black.
Born in Australia. I'll say that quietly though, Murray.
Roe Harding.
No. Sam Harding, born in Australia. So here's Nicky Little. He got the first one over. It was fairly easy. This one a little more difficult, and he's gone to the right. Major. Well, it's difficult as the water splashes up inside the 22. It's kicked ahead by Rumbini. That's a forward pass as Kelleher and Major exchange the passes.
Yes. Well, pass the pass, it looked like to me.
Okay, get the crouch and hold.
And chip kicks like that in broken play, you almost always turn it over.
Well, a night like tonight, really, the kick along the ground is far more effective. Rumbuka now, it's away for Kelleher, and good covering defence.
That's a rock, stay out of it, White.
Rabbi Verata, the number 8. Gibson. Lomu again coming very quickly. And Norman Laguerre on the right wing for the Fijians did the right thing. Play not really running to the left wing as yet for Jonah. We've seen him get involved a couple of times.
Well, it's interesting to see Case Mews at the back of this New Zealand lineup. Perhaps one of the reasons he's getting to the breakdown.
Not thrown straight. by Tom Willis. No real excuses tonight. No wind to speak of, Smithy?
Absolutely none. There's no far from the moisture. No, I think the players are handling the conditions admirably though so far. It's an outstanding display of rugby from what we thought it might be.
Pressure coming on this Fijian scrum. We've seen them hold right on the goal line the opening minutes of the game. I don't know how fit Fabian Barty is, but he's got to be a key member of this team. He's the tight head prop. He's been playing club rugby in the Wairarapa. It'll be a different pace. Well, club rugby in Wellington, but living in the Wairarapa, it'll be a different pace of game here today.
Good effort here by Callaghan. Gets round on Raluni and makes life very difficult. Well, it was a bit hard to know there who was offside and who wasn't.
Yeah, I agree with you. It was a lottery, wasn't it? Because Callaghan was absolutely legit and he was about a foot in front of the guy that got penalised.
Raluni, as we've seen in the Super 12 for the Reds, is a player who does get rattled. And Callaghan will know that. He'll be right after him.
He'll be doing the rattling, will he?
Rattling the cage. In this case, maybe the rib cage.
So here's Nicky Little, just making sure it goes out. Let's go back and check the scrum. This is Joe McDonnell against Big Billy.
Well, he was holding. Bill was holding. Slight angle, though, I thought.
Good clean line-out take by Suwumbu for the Fijians. Now, this is up off the ground and some more. But they've managed to get it back nicely. Taken out by Smith. Got his pass away for Raluni. Now Little. And this is the story in these conditions. Lomu having to get back. Cullen is with him. And Cullen could do nothing else except kick it. Here's Big Bill. Now here's something to look forward to. Boom, buddy, boom. Whoa!
The crowd loved him.
Here come the Fijians. And Little spies a gap. The goal line is right there. Raluni hands it on for Raiwalui, the experienced lock forward. Raluni again. Now Little, once more. Underneath, one tackle goes Satala. Umanga not looking too comfortable. Now Satala again. But the defence holding up well. Taken off for Satala by Dallasau. Playing an advantage here, the referee. And
no advantage. Offside.
And again, the All Blacks offside. And this is in precisely the same area as think, the first penalty.
I think Tane Umanga's got big problems. And I think it's his name to see him limping behind the goalpost. He didn't want to stand up before. It was he didn't want to. He just couldn't, I don't think. He realised it was desperate. The defence plugged the hole. His hand firmly on it. That's not a great sign going into that try series.
The big problems with the knee late in Super 12 and through the early stages of this international season. Didn't appear to have any problems last weekend for the New Zealand Barbarians. It's not looking too good at the moment.
Just the action though, the way he spoke to the physio was like he got tackled on that leg as though it was driven backwards.
So Little with his second successful penalty goal and the All Blacks lead is 13 points to 6.
Now Umanga's played very well so far in defence. He's stopped at least one try. Watch him move across back into position and he takes the next man. Boom. And then he follows up with a copybook tackle on somebody who was really going to get through otherwise. But then he lets it go.
Now back live with the kickoff. 7-point advantage for the All Blacks. 2 tries to 0. Raluni a little bit slow to clear. But Little gets good distance. Down as far as the big guy, Jonah Lomu. Now Cullen. Very nearly slipped through. Found Callaghan. Now Randall. stops and sets it up. 10 out from the 22. All Blacks might be a little bit short here without Umanga. Not sure whether they brought the replacement player on yet. So Major decides to go into the air. The chaser is Howlett. And it's beautifully claimed by Uliadewi.
Lisbo, no player on as yet. Umanga's about to leave the park, and it will be McDonald coming in. They've got two options, I guess. They could have brought Mertens on at first 5-8 and shifted everyone out one, but they're going for the McDonald option in jersey 22.
Looks like Umanga's gone for the night. And let's just see where Leon McDonald slots in.
This stage, he's slotted in outside Darryl Gibson, so he's just centre for centre.
White three.
Oh, right there it is.
Yes, he got the foot trapped in the ruck.
Caught backwards and just ripped. His body was ripped backwards. And he's not the sort of guy that leaves the field easy, Tana Umanga, so I'd be pretty worried about the fortnight's time in Christchurch.
So Leon McDonald goes into midfield for his 16th test match as the All Blacks free it up for Kelleher. Now Major across to McDonald, having a crack in midfield, and welcome to the show as he gets nailed. Now Maxwell back into Thorne. Referee has got the arm out. All Black advantage. Major drops it onto the foot for Howlett to chase. Lovely kick. Skidding over the wet surface, and that's out. And that should be All Black ball too.
And that was a brilliant kick by Major. He didn't intend on kicking. He clearly wanted to pass that ball. When he looked up, he saw the back line was in disarray.
Well, the referee said that the line out had already formed. That could have been a big moment for Christian Cullen. Now look at this. He put his feet out. Now that's pretty average stuff, really. And it gave the All Black the ball. The All Blacks the ball.
Christian Cullen looking for that big try. New Zealand ball, great attacking position.
So Willis goes for Reuben Thorne. Randall takes it. Willis gets it back.
Moving the centre of attack out one.
Here goes Case Mews. Case Mews gets the third try for the All Blacks tonight.
Well, he was a little bit short and he just shrugged his way over. Same movement, although it was sort of a bit stop-start. Let's have a little look at it on replay. So they moved the centre of attack out one to make it easier. The other forwards came in. Okay, so the story is he wasn't held, is what the call must have been. Wasn't held in the tackle.
I told you Murray's like a bottle of home brew, ready to explode. He's exploded.
Worried about that home brew, what happens when the bottle's empty, Chris?
Well, that's after 80 minutes, we hope.
Been a big year so far for All Black prop forward, scoring tries. Aaron Major. Looks like this one's on target. Nice kick.
Well, once props get into a habit of scoring tries, it seems to continue. It's almost as though it's just reminding them that they can score tries, and they really enjoy it, of course, props when they score tries. But they don't get the opportunity that some of the backs do with a flood of possession and sometimes free space and finishing movements.
A couple of test tries for Case Mews now.
Okay.
As Randall sets it for the All Blacks. Now Kelleher, Major, goes the other way this time. Just out from his 22, confronted by Lomu. And just gains a couple of metres. He didn't have too many options. He was pretty lonely.
So that's Alfred Ulunao, originally from Auckland.
Let's go line out straight in front of where they're attending to Tana Umanga. The attention is on the inside of the right knee.
Leap by Mailing once more. Darryl Gibson placing it nicely.
That's a rock, hands out wide.
Kelleher again for Mailing.
Rock ball.
Now they set it alight to the left. Here's McDonald's. very versatile player, Leon McDonald, but the Fijians scooping up the loose ball. Now there's room out in centre field for Sam Harding, but hang on, whistle's gone, and the flag is up across on the far side.
Well, Fijians quick to snaffle that ball. So it was set up by McDonald. Nobody there from New Zealand. Beautifully stolen. That's a turnover. So Rai Wai Lui, who plays in Newport, Wales, so he'll be used to these conditions. Slippery, wet conditions. There's plenty of that in Wales.
Tip forward by the Fijian players as Willis drives it, and here's McDonnell. As the All Blacks go towards the 22, Kelleher, nice hands from Major. Gibson now to Lomu, steps his way through the first one. All Blacks worried in the couple of tests against Ireland, they weren't cleaning out well enough. Cleaning out pretty well tonight. Here's Byron Kelleher getting isolated. But there was no advantage.
The ruck was born. Hands out of it.
So what will they do? Will they take the three? Will they go for the corner? Or will they take the tap?
Got to say, Murray, that the quality of the passing, both backs and forwards, has been far, far better than in either of the tests against Ireland. It's a very good sign. Look at the quality of this stuff. Look at the pickup. Major's pickup, great. Good pass out in front, Gibson. Back inside again. Lomu, something he can run onto, get a bit of momentum. It's looking good.
Well, it is, and I mean, I guess for the viewers at home, it's such a clear picture. Sometimes you can't see the rain and the wetness on the pitch. It's been pouring with rain before this game, and it's still been raining throughout the opening 20 minutes.
Willis deep for Mailing once more. Well controlled in here. Tom Willis has it.
And the ball's at the back, and those front drivers are just carrying on. Well, it's a great try. It deserves a try.
And the try is scored by Norm Maxwell. So Maxwell gets in the act as well. And the All Blacks come up with their fourth tonight and his fourth.
Well, it is a copybook try. Beautiful example of what to do as the rain continues to fall. Let's have a look at this. Taken in beautifully by Mailing. The driver's set up. The players come in behind. The ball has moved back from that front line. There it is. It's slipped back. Now right back to right Maxwell right at the end. Now, as long as they're all bound, as long as those front guys keep on driving, it's just follow the leader stuff. And he did. And then he became the leader when he crashed over the line.
Major's kick from a handy position is over. Norm Maxwell scores the fourth try tonight. The All Blacks go out to 27-6.
Well, I like the other aspects of the All Black play that Chris has been talking about. The line-out seems to be going a lot better tonight. Two options, Mailing at the back, Thorn at the front.
Get back.
And they've also won two against the throw, two Smithy. One by Maxwell and one by Randall, I think.
Here's Doug Howlett. Got a nasty bounce, but coped with it well.
Ruck, hands out wide, stay inside. And out here too.
Kelleher for Major. Not such a good kick this time, although it's an awkward bounce. Villeneuve looking to get it in behind Kalanoa. Nice kick. What a great kick by Alfred Villeneuve. Once it was over Cullen's head, it was going to be effective.
Well, they've done well actually, the Fijians, in that situation, in this situation, this part of the game. Particularly they've found space on numerous occasions kicking the ball. I'm not sure if it's positional play or whether it's just magnificent kicking in poor conditions.
Just under 10 minutes remaining in the first half. As the All Blacks go long down to Randall.
Yeah,
and not straight. Tane Randall, 48th cap tonight. Former captain of the All Blacks, of course.
Tane Randall is playing better this year, I think, than he's probably ever played in his career. He's matured, he's tougher,
He's more uncompromising on the tackle and he's always in position.
Well, he made his debut in the 1997 match against the Fijians, so he'll remember that fondly for sure. And since that time, as I said, 48 test matches. Now 19, of course, as the captain of the All Blacks.
Well, he's a mature campaigner. And although there's a lot of people differing in opinion on this, I still believe his best position is number 8.
Wait, crouch and hold. Engage. Come on.
That's where he is tonight. That's where he's been on at scrum time throughout the Super 12. Watch where he is now. Look at him viewing the defensive role.
Hey, keep out of it.
Things getting a little feisty in the front row. Got a finger pointing.
Yeah, hold it, blood. Blood again, you've got some blood here. No, you've got
some blood here. That's Muse, yeah.
Well, it was Greg Smith doing the pointing, but it's Case Muse with the blood. So I wonder what happened down there.
Let's have a look.
Yes, yeah, obviously.
It's not often a prop gets away with a shot like that, is it?
But I think it was retaliation.
Yes. But usually it's the retaliator that gets punished. No punishment at all. That's good. Yeah,
well, maybe you could see the blood pressure. It's pretty graphic proof, isn't it?
Stand up.
The scrum breaks up all of a sudden, and a prop hits a hooker, and the prop's bleeding. Well, pretty obvious.
Ralooney now off to the right they go, and a shot at the line by Lagiri. Stolen away by Jonah. Ball lost forward though.
Well, great play, Jonah. Get fired up, Jonah.
Mark's here.
Let's have a look at this here.
Crash and hold.
So he's in for the tackle. He rips the ball free. He goes for it. Good start.
That's a good sign, isn't it? That's a very good sign.
I'd give him the ball right now. That's what they want to do. Give it to him now. He's running hot. He even wants it.
Crouch and holds the shoulder.
Not their ball, though, of course.
Engage. It'd
be great if Ralooney passed the ball to De La Sau, though.
No. Away for Little instead. Good defence in midfield. McDonald hitting Satala head on.
Madness is over.
Clearing kick made by Major. Ilianau has been an outstanding figure in the match so far. This time he's well taken though by Leon McDonald. And it's against Doug Howlett. Quickly taken. It's only just a matter of centimetres, but Scott Young wants them to take it from exactly the right place.
That's right. A bit pedantic, isn't it? But Maxwell gave away the penalty. He came in and the referee clearly said off his feet. I guess the only out there, let's have a look, is that Maxwell considered it wasn't a ruck or maul, it was just purely a tackle, but even so. So Howlett's right, Maxwell arrives.
Here's the penalty, probably against Norm Maxwell.
That's what we did. No, that's it.
So knocked forward.
Mark's here.
New Zealand ball. So what are they going to do here?
Have
you got any suggestions what might happen here? Chris, you could perhaps help me here.
Well,
would you move it or would you?
They'll go wide.
Do you think they will in these conditions under the sticks?
No, they're going to take it up the middle.
They don't need to probably spin it underneath their goalposts, I guess.
Good powerful punt by Byron Kelleher. Well, you know, decides to work it into midfield. Nicely taken in by Bill Satala, the man who plays his rugby in France. Stade Montois.
Up it, hands out.
Hands it off again. Good positioning this time from Cullen. Immediately heaves it off to Randall, who seems to be all over the park tonight. And a beautifully timed punt again by Aaron Major. They don't seem to be having so much of a problem with the ball tonight, even though it's a fairly wet night.
Yeah, well, I don't know if there is a problem, really. I mean, I guess it's a parallel with golfer could be if a golfer changes his clubs, does he hit it as well the first time out, the first time he goes around the golf course? I mean, the second test against Ireland, Mervyn's was hitting the ball magnificently well. I'm sure it's just getting used to the different type of ball, the Adidas ball.
He said, using the golfing analogy, Murray, I never improve. Nothing ever happens to me. So we've got a few minutes remaining in the first half. The All Blacks have scored four tries to nil. Very competitive start by the Fijians.
Yes, they have mixed it. They've competed. They're not just trying to keep the New Zealand score down. They're actually having a crack. So I think that's commendable for sure. They've held up at scrum time still, and it's almost half time.
Taking it almost up to halfway. And the ball has been played on the ground by an All Black.
Well, technically that's right, but it was a turnover and the ball was there. It's a bit of an unnecessary rule, really, when the ball's available like that. Sometimes it's a lot easier just to scoop it back. In fact, they trialled this in the Super 12 this year for the development teams, where the players could play the ball on the ground in that situation.
Get 10.
Yes, we often feel it's just another reason to stop the game, isn't it?
Yes.
More reasons to keep it going, the better.
Now that's another throw, another line out against the throw. Remember, the last one was by
Hands
Maxwell.
Hands out of it, White. Get out of it. Leave him.
Major hops onto the left boot this time. Not quite the same amount of power. So he gives Norman Laguerre an opportunity to go for a run. But closed down. 5 metres on the All Black side of halfway. There it is for Raluni. Tending to run across field just a little too often. Making themselves sitting targets, the Fijians. They need someone to straighten it. Muse has lost a forward.
Playing advantage.
Now Raluni. Here's Kavambadi. Nice little pass. Now the man who can straighten it up is Rambini. Again, it's turned over. Here's Harding, who's got great acceleration. As he gets to the halfway line, and now Kelleher sends it off to McDonald. Straight past them all goes McDonald, lobs it away to Lomu. Couldn't quite find Cullen on the inside, but a lovely thrusting run by Leon McDonald as they take it quickly. Here's McDonald again. The referee was playing advantage. They worked the 10 metres.
Well, the two biggest roars on this crowd is when Bill Favambadi gets the ball and Jonah Lomu. It's a classic. It's almost as though Bill Favambadi's a local hero. Of course, they've seen his rampaging runs down the centre of the field here in Wellington before.
Well, this will be interesting, Murray. See Sam Harding race away into open territory there. This is the same position the All Blacks drove from last time. Thorne did have a word to Mailing. He's down the back again.
You notice Christian Cullen up there, perfect timing again. He's got his timing back.
Well, they'll have to do the same thing now, Smithy. They'll have to pick it up and drive, and that's what they're trying to do. There's a Fijian forward in the way.
Here they go to the line, close again. Again, it's advantage.
Stationary ball. Turn it into another ruck, perhaps.
Randall wants to set it once more. Not going to be any way through there.
So this one will have to be scrum, surely.
Gallagher's going to feed it wide now. Lomu. Underneath him. Good defence by Rambini. And Kelleher takes it to the mark once more. We're having a little tussle, aren't they?
Yeah.
The Waikato man against the Otago man.
Waikato man again, was it? Is it? Greg Smith again.
You'll
see more
now.
Of it.
Same thing with the fire up there, right? Have a chat to
very
team.
Quietly spoken man, Greg Smith.
Came round at the ruck,
very
mate.
Nice fellow.
Offside,
but, he's pretty combative and competitive on the field.
No, that's 5 seconds to go. Sorry, yeah.
5 seconds to go, so they can't kick it out. And so Ruben Thorne says, let's have a scrum, see if we can score.
Just take it back a step, please.
Before half time.
Well, they'll have to have a go. Five seconds to go, 40 minutes of scrummaging. Let's see what happens here.
Last act of the first half as Randall hands it off to Kelleher. Now they go to Lomu.
Let it go.
He took the ball almost standing still. So Kelleher goes again for Major. Gibson. Cullen runs the dummy. Now it's Howlett. Not a lot of room to move. Head high tackle, and that'll be a penalty. So advantage applies as the All Blacks threaten once more. Here's Case Mews. He's got one already. Struggling to go again, and he does. Two tries in the first half to Case Mews.
Well, he's making a statement. He's got the taste of that goal line. Well, once you've had the taste.
The taste of home brew.
White seven.
He's really doing it tonight, isn't he? Good lead-up. Very good lead-up work, too. Howlett looks as if he was going to the outside. Comes back in.
Howlett just got lost his head. It was a great drive, wasn't it? And then it
good
topped
solid
out.
Drive.
And Mews had a go, and he wasn't content. He was going to get it over that goal line. Yeah, well.
On one knee, on both knees, and then the ball goes over. I suppose you'd have to say that was fair.
Well, you're allowed to plant the ball if it's in one movement. Yes. It's still the same movement.
Whether it was the same movement is debatable, but never mind. It's on the board.
Five tries in the first half for the All Blacks. And Aaron Major with this conversion, and he won't get it round again, so that will be it. Half time at the stadium in Wellington. Case Mews, number three, has picked up two of those five tries, and the All Blacks go to the changing sheds leading by 32-6.
Well, the Fijians have come to compete. There's no doubt about that, and compete they have. They've been really heady at the beginning of this game, but they haven't really had the firepower. They've been having a crack at the All Blacks in the midfield. They haven't really breached the defence apart from kicking over the top. And the New Zealand team has been accurate, precise, and determined, starting with big drives and scoring tries through the middle. I guess that must have been the tempo, must have been the intention before the beginning of this game. The conditions so wet, and the style of their game ideally suited for it.
Case Mews has scored two tries in the first half. The others going to Cullen, Howlett and Maxwell. And the All Blacks lead at the break here in Wellington by 32-6. Half time at the WestpacTrust Stadium in Wellington. The All Blacks have scored five first half tries to two penalty goals by Nicky Little. 32-6 at the break.
This game was something of a test for Aaron Major, and he came through with flying colours, kicked a remarkable goal. His touch kicking and his kicking into space was excellent. Judgment, you couldn't fault throughout the game. This kick in particular was absolutely inch perfect. And watch this moment here. We see two players here, two dummy runners. Major then takes it on, a lovely lateral pass to Tanu Umanga, another lovely slip pass. And Cullen backing up with perfect timing again. And the first try was a real gem. The next try was almost as good. A very slow pass to Howlett, who gets past his man. And watch this. A jump, a catch, a real individual try. Shades of Jeff Wilson. Then Case Mews decided to get into the game. Driving, the All Black forward play at this stage, about halfway through the first half, was really very, very good. The tries were bound to come. Maxwell got his. After good build-ups, good precise passing, fairly adventurous in these kind of conditions. The odd high shot from Fiji. You notice the All Black forward pack working much better together. And Case Mews comes through again. A low-flying missile that eventually gets across the line. And he did other things around the field too. He was very prominent in this game. He's had an excellent first half. The line-out work has been great from the All Blacks' point of view. It's been precise. The driving has been good. The catching, the throwing, everything about it has been exemplary. Fiji have been in it too. They've done their best. They've had moments when they've tried to attack. They've been a little bit too fancy, I think, with the passing occasionally. Big Billy had one major run, and that was all it came to, and that's all it's come to for Fiji so far.
One of the negative aspects of the first half the injury to Tata Rumanga looks pretty sad about it all. It looks like the right knee might be in trouble once again, and the ice is on it. So that is a disappointment from the All Blacks' point of view. We'll have to await developments. Now let's check the stats in the first half. Murray?
Well, it makes it interesting reading. I think the top one's the most interesting, really, the score on the board, 32-6. But have a look down the left-hand side. It's not as dominant as one would have imagined with a score like that, 54-60. Rucks and mauls even, not a great disparity. Turnovers one is quite significant at a rate of 2-1. Kicks and play is really interesting, isn't it? 58 kicks and play, that's a lot of kicks in one half. But really, I think it all boils down to control and organisation, and that's what New Zealand has had. Fiji, on the other hand, have been free-ranging and spirited, but not really sticking it all together.
So a lot to look forward to in the second half here at the Westpac Trust Stadium in Wellington. The All Blacks have the lead over Fiji at half-time by 32-6. Both sides back on the field at the Westpac Trust Stadium, and we'll be underway again in just a couple of minutes' time. It's been a big first half for Case Muse for the All Blacks. Two tries, and he becomes the first All Black prop since Richard Lowe against the World 15 in 1992 to score two tries in a test match. Nobody's managed three, so that's something to look for in the next 40 minutes. So Case Muse certainly holding his hand up for tonight. Before we get underway, well, we need a referee for a start off. Smithy, I think we might have a replacement on the Fijian side.
Yeah, looks like the hooker, Greg Smith, the skipper. I think he was battling going into the match. In fact, just approaching me on the touchline, limping quite badly. And they're supposed to say, yeah, he's been replaced in jersey 16. And that is, for me, Rasila.
So 40 minutes each for the hookers. Greg Smith came in under a big crowd with a broken toe, but he gave it his best shot.
You're right.
And we're set to go here. Second half. Aaron Major gets the second spell underway here in Wellington, and the ball lost back, and Little has to make a hurried kick down to Jonah. Claims it quickly and hands it off to Cullen, who scored the first try of the match. That's the halfway line as Kelleher. A lot of kicking in the match, as we saw. Big turn there for Big Billy Thavambati. And he saw the amusing part of it. A quick word with Doug Howlett. Yeah, he's allowed, a cheerful character.
He is, but allowed everybody to see how far out of position he was. Christian Cullen have a go. Watch Jonah Longo in support here. Christian ran into trouble. Jonah in behind him, driving them backwards. It was a great turnover.
So a new hooker on the field for the Fijians, Rasila. Now here's wing three-quarter Ligiri. Haven't had a real opportunity to see some of these outstanding backs that the Fijians do possess. Lomu gets another go. This time he might decide to have a crack on his own. Slips a pass, pretty awkward, but well picked up by Callan. Away he goes. Now it's Howlett. Leon McDonald on the field for Tana Umanga. And the All Blacks have it just out from the 22. Now Willis, supported by Maxwell.
Willis was trying to set up a maul.
Major, who can be a damaging runner. Now it's McDonald across for Lomu. Here he goes. Just was in touch. So he tried to lob it back in field. But you heard the crowd response the moment Lomu got the ball.
Lovely pass from Leon McDonald. Look at that. Right into his breadbasket. Gives Jonah a chance to get some momentum.
I don't know if he was out then. His feet were still off the ground when he passed it in.
Rasila, important throw this. Oh, and he's mistimed it badly. And the All Blacks have great attacking options here. Away to Darryl Gibson. Now McDonald. Here's Howlett with his pace. Doug Howlett on the outside. Flicks it back and feel it's off the boot. And that's a try, I reckon, to Leon McDonald.
Well, that's a great try. That is a great try. Pretty interesting, really, to see Howlett all guns blazing. But he's got against a very, very fast opponent, Dallas South. one of the quickest in the business. He threw himself to the deck, which was a cool move. I thought, have a look at this. He could see that he wasn't going to make the goal line, so he didn't want to be pushed into touch. He hit the deck and pushed the ball infield, and it was carefully towed ahead by McDonald. Very astute move, and he won the race to recover it and score.
How about the handling too? Cullen, we saw a beautiful pickup from him for the poor Lomu pass. And gee, beautiful pickup there from the goal kicker here, Aaron Major, to set that up. So the All Blacks' skills tonight have been quite outstanding.
Aaron Major converted two tries in the first half. And just under. So Leon McDonald has scored his sixth test try. And this was clever. Howlett did the right thing, and notice how McDonald just kept the hands out of it, and the try presented itself.
Real stroke of genius there from McDonald. It shows just what an accomplished footballer he really is.
Yes, he's very balanced, very balanced, very safe.
Major again. And what a joy it is to see a man who's equally comfortable on his left boot as he is on his right. Here's Cullen in a bit of space, but he surveyed the options and decided the kick is the way to go. Well, you know, lined up by McDonald and Willis. Looking to get it wide. They really do have some tremendous pace out there, and very nearly slipped through. How they are. Big opportunity. The kick and chase is made. Howlett having to get back. Now, can he control it? That's brilliantly done. Outstanding, Doug Howlett. Lays it back on the 22. He's had a top game out on the right wing side. Has Howlett. And there's a knock on by Byron Kelleher. But we've seen some wonderful moments tonight from Doug Howlett, and this is one of them.
Well, he's shown all a full range of tools in the shed, that's for sure. Have a look at this. Is copy book back, sliding back so you don't knock it on, and then getting up in instant action, acceleration away from the tackle, but also beating a man off his left foot.
Rao Looney serves it up to Little. The charge coming from Rambini. All Black defences held the Fijians out tonight. Now they come wide for Legere, looking to go round Lomu, does so, and Legere has waltzed in. Outside of Lomu, inside of Cullen, and a wonderful try scored by Norman Legere.
Well, a piece of individual magic, reminiscent of Howlett in the first half. He beat Jonah on the outside. Let's have a little look at it. And then he stepped inside Christian Cullen with ease. So he's got plenty of room to move like Howlett did. Yes, the same thing. It's inside-outside break, tiptoeing through the tulips on the touchline, and then sidestepping Cullen.
Yes, he just made Jonah hesitate that half second. And then a shifter off the right foot. Nobody could stop that. Certainly not in these conditions.
And I think Jonah grasped high to the first attempt, and of course there was no chance for a second attempt.
Fijian side always managed to get a try in their test against the All Blacks, and this was a classic from the right winger Legere, who stood Lomu up. He went high, which was never going to do any good. Cullen was on, really, a hiding to nothing. On a slippery surface, he was always going to get done. There was nothing much he could do about it. The problem lay a little earlier. Rao Looney for Little. Lomu and Cullen together. Can't do much from here. Oh, skills. Now there'll be a smile here, yep.
Well, finally a smile, but I think it was more frustration. He thought, oh, I've got another piece of action here. I've been sitting back here 50 metres just waiting for a loose kick.
And it was a loose kick. A very loose kick.
He He's a delightful fellow, Big Billy. Became something of a cult figure around Wellington rugby circles a few years ago. Willis goes down the back to Mayling, who's done the job well tonight. Major for Gibson, now Lomu, bit of a juggle, then he gets going. Good solid defence by the Fijians, led by Little. But the ball is there for Kelleher. They look to be a little offside. Here he goes, Case Muse. Had a huge contribution to make in this game tonight. Kelleher away for Major. They're running hard here. Major. Now they all come. Major himself. What a brilliant try again.
Well, it was another classic. Well, he's shown beautiful touch tonight, Aaron Major, right from the start of this game. He hasn't been greedy at all. Well, here's another man who's vying for the man of the match. There's three of them in contention in my mind at the moment. Howlett, Muse and also Major. But look at the way he kept his legs pumping. He wasn't happy to be pulled down. He wasn't going to stop. He was just going to keep on going, getting every yard he could. And then Major, of course, running onto the ball, the Fijians running back. It makes things like this possible if you've got the ability, the skill, the style, the timing.
But you've also got to have speed as well. And he beat that Fijian fullback for sheer speed. And that's a good sign.
Fullback had to turn, though.
He had to turn, but then it was just a straight foot race. And Major got ahead of him.
Scored his second test try in the process. And he's going to convert it too. To make it 44 points to 11.
It is, but this will make John Mitchell feel a little happier, but I think his mind will still be thinking about the one conceded at the other end of 2 or 3 minutes ago. He told us last week after the game, this All Black side values that last white line very dearly. He'll be angry at that try conceded.
Yes, they conceded just the one against Ireland in two tests. Willis sets it. Kelleher to Major. Now Uliano brings it back for Davu Brata, the number 8 forward. Now Little. Back inside, there's Norm Maxwell making a powerful tackle, as he often does. Ball turned over. It's with Harding. And the All Blacks have it back. Kelleher, the little kick in behind on the greasy surface, can be effective. Oh, here's trouble. Uliano kicked it into another Fijian player. He has another go at it, and this time he will get it out, but... It was offside, I suspect.
I think it's a late charge there on Kelleher when he kicked through. I think that's what he was looking at, Scott Young.
It looked like Byron Kelleher played for that too, Smithy.
Didn't look particularly comfortable with the ball on the ground. Really, no. Cut.
Let's get that mark there, Greg. He's within 10.
So that was the late charge there. Now this was a real scramble.
Well, a mixture of the ball spinning around like a top, and of course the the wetness of the ball as well.
Yeah, that's what I'm going for. So it was white five, yeah. Okay.
The pluvial conditions.
Okay.
Pluvial conditions. Oh no! Oh no! Exposed again.
Fluvial. It's all got to do with water anyway, one way or another.
I'll let you guys work it out. It's raining, isn't it?
Okay, thanks, mate. Yeah. Just with that last tackle, you didn't use any arms. It was a bit late as well. Yeah.
Looks like we might lose Jacob Rowlooney, Smithy.
Yeah, Samisoni Rambaka in jersey 20, replacing a very, very experienced campaigner here. He was doing his best to hold that pack together from behind and sorting them on. So they lose a lot there, the Fijians.
Get the gap across, White.
So Tom Willis, as play resumes, about 11 minutes into the second half, Willis gets the ball back from Randall. The All Blacks are still about 15 metres short.
Get it out.
Scott Young wants the ball out, and it is out. Major, good hands again. Quickly heaved on by Cullen. Great work by him into the arms of Howlett. wasn't controlled there, and here's an opportunity for the Fijians. That's beautifully snapped up by Dalasau on the left wing side, but again the ball control is not good and it's lost forward.
Beautiful sense by Christian Cullen. He could just feel he was going to take the tackle and all at the same time. Have a look at this. Boom, boom.
That's the sort of thing that wasn't working a few weeks ago. It's nice to see it working again now.
So eradicate the errors. It must have been the call for the last couple of weeks, Chris.
Sorry, yeah.
Well, if it was, it's certainly working. This has been, handling-wise, this has been an outstanding display. There have been a few faults here and there, but boy, the handling has been marvellous.
Looks like a bit of glad wrap there around the knee.
Scott Robertson waiting the call. Tane Randall looks like he's damaged his calf muscle. So he goes to the sideline. Off comes the gloves. Looks like a batsman heading back to the pavilion, Smithy.
Yeah, looks like one on a low score too. That was the look on his face. Not too happy. Another chance for Scott Robertson in a very competitive position. Just thinking back to what a big game Case Muse is having tonight. Must have got a little agitated watching Greg Somerville run around Eden Park like this time last week.
Yeah, well, that's what competition's all about. I think that's what John Mitchell and Robbie Deans are trying to foster in this All Black squad.
Well, I think they're achieving it, and for that reason alone, the Phillips International Series has been a great success today.
So Scott Robertson comes into the number eight job, immediately gets a touch. Lomu hands it away to Major. Here's an intercept, and it'll be all over. It's the same man again, Norman Laguerre, and that's his second.
Well, it is really the hallmark of the Fijians. Expect the unexpected. They've been like this for years. It's a characteristic of their play. They can pull off an intercept, a sleight of hand, something against the run of play, really. But it was timed, it was read, it was anticipated, and it was finished.
The problem is you could see this coming a mile off, and it was Jonah's pass that was a bit too slow, and by the time the ball got out there, he was in and away.
He'll remember this night as long as he lives. Two tries against the All Blacks, little converts, and it's 44-18. Norman Laguerre, right wing three quarter, has made his mark.
At 44-18, I'd say that Ruben Thorne would be saying, okay, now let's tidy this act up, let's tighten up the ship.
Here's the man of the moment himself, forced to kick, down to his opposite.
Have a go, Jonah.
Yep, there he does too. Boom.
Yes, and everyone loves it. So do those forwards, they get something to drive over, although they got penalised.
And presumably it was Jonah holding on for too long. Rambaka playing with a bit of confidence now. The Fijians, kick is made. Gibson having to go back.
You see how much more easily the Fijians get into the game when it becomes looser and it starts to lose its structure. This is exactly the kind of thing they want. It's going to be tough to get to the All Black, particularly the forwards, to reimpose themselves here.
Well, we know this team really predominantly Fijian players as a seven-a-side group, players that are spectacular as individuals and with small numbers on the field. There have been moments, of course, in the history. Brad Johnson had them in the last World Cup, and cast your mind back, you remember how unlucky they were by a referee's decision not to beat France and make a semi-final.
Trying to keep it in, not able to do so though, as it went to Dalasau.
They also won the Pacific Rim last year, of course, a tournament that's a fierce competition in the islands.
It's staggering to think though, Murray, that an All Black team hasn't been to Fiji since 1984. I think you might have been in that team, weren't you?
It was indeed. And now in those days, of course, it wasn't called a test match.
It's a bit of a disgrace, really, that the All Blacks have largely ignored the Fijians. I know that proceeds are going to this game, but they would love to see them in Suva, they'd love to see them in Apia, and that was a huge collision. And there's a couple of bodies, and Leon McDonald is down. Oh dear, there's a lot of blood there. Nasty wound. Leon McDonald.
keep him down, right?
Yes, it was okay. A head clash.
Sorry?
So the pass.
No, it's all good.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely accidental. Both of them KO'd. He's such an aggressive runner, Leon McDonald.
Okay, thanks, mate.
Head forward.
Yeah, I got that one there. Just to track it out
so. Number seven, Collie Siwambu, in collision with Leon McDonald. And Andrew Mertens, as you can see, preparing to come on. And there'll be some stitches needed here.
There may be a bit of concussion as well, too. That sort of blow when you're hit.
Absolutely right, Chris. You're absolutely right. And what sort of impact does that have on the All Black thinking? McDonald was probably a shot's eye, wasn't he, in the 15 jersey? So,
yes.
Well, Christian Cullen.
You watch this. He goes straight into a shoulder blade. Opened up his eyebrows as well, yeah. So yeah. Mertens comes on at 10 and DeMajor moves out. Is that the plan?
The way he moved around, though, it didn't look like he was stunned or concussed immediately. And one thing about head wounds, of course, they heal very quickly. Cuts in that area where there's plenty of blood rushing around. Oh, yes.
Straight into the shoulder blade.
Oh, dear.
I think it was head on head, Chris, actually. Yeah. It was the forehead of...
Whatever it was bone.
Forehead of Siwambu.
They don't want Leon McDonald to get up at this stage. I think they're asking for a stretcher. So that is a sad sight. He's a wonderful rugby player. He's made a big contribution tonight. Now Andrew Mertens runs in for his 58th test match. And so he'll go in to first five for sure. Major will move out.
Jens have made a replacement. There's no Wallace is going on. Mortalutu in jersey 19 is on for the injured flanker. So it was head on head without doubt.
Well, it's a huge collision. Totally accidental. And both players will be out of the game.
There's a little bit of a timing issue on the pass, wasn't it? It was set up quite high.
The pass was just a shade late, I think. He held it and held it and then let it go. By that time, the Fijian defence was right on them. We've been watching the lineouts, and it's been all good for the All Blacks tonight. It's been precise. The throws have been good. Willis has been exceptionally good on the throw. There hasn't been a single lineout mess-up. Boy, were we saying that a couple of years ago. That's a very encouraging feature.
So a number of replacements on the All Blacks side here tonight, with Umanga and Randall having already left. McDonald about to join them. Two tries each in the second half. Rather somber looking All Blacks waiting for Leon McDonald to be stretchered from the field.
Yeah, it did right, but it's actually quite an eerie sight, isn't it, to see the whole 15 of them just standing there looking only metres away.
Players not used so far tonight. Chris Jack there and Dave Hewitt, Mark Hammett.
So which one of those three would go on if another back left the field? Come on.
Well, that's right. It's
a lottery. I'd say Chris Jack.
I'd say Justin Marshall myself.
Ah, forgot about Justin. Justin time.
I suspect Justin Marshall would come on anywhere, any position, any time, just to be there.
I can see Chris Jack playing first 5-8, though.
Yes, well, he is a brilliant player. He's the CEO of New Zealand Rugby there, David Rutherford.
Along with the Mayor of Wellington.
Kerry Prendergast. Good to see the Mayor here.
Well, the Mayor is always here. This is it. This is the Wellington Stadium.
Peter Bush. Bushy. Well, he's been here a few times.
Yeah, more often than Kerry Prendergast, I think.
I like his gold jumper. Yeah. That's very nice,
well,
isn't it?
Always been rather chic, hasn't he, Bushy?
I'm not sure he'd agree with you there.
No, he'd be horrified. The pose. The poise.
So a long hold up here as Leon McDonald is attended to. Being very careful.
It's obviously safety first factor here, but this must be a fair sized cut on his head, I would imagine.
Well, he's got a lot to show for tonight, hasn't he? He's scored one try, he's made a couple of others. He's a player who understands the importance of space, and he'll be pretty satisfied with his game so far tonight. It's a bit of a tragedy whenever this sort of thing happens.
Applause now for Leon McDonald. Good to see him. Murray was chatting away there to the attendants.
We just hope it's not concussion. This concussion is taken very seriously these days. And you're out for a couple of weeks at least. So he'll be off for analysis.
It's certainly a good sign to see him talking for sure. So that would indicate that maybe he's not too bad.
Long break, and Andrew Mertens will move into first 5-8. Aaron Major, who's done a wonderful job in place of Mertens, moves out one. Mailing drags it down. It might be difficult now for the All Blacks to get momentum going again. Might take a wee while. Inside the 22. To free it now or the whistle will blow. Pretty messy.
One side! No, he's turned around. Easy, guys.
All Blacks will kick for the touchline and restart with the line-out. They've scored 7 tries to 2 tonight. And we're getting up towards the halfway mark in the second spell.
If I was a gambling man, I'd bet dollars to donuts that they'll be driving this. Be taking it and driving it. Might even move the attack, maybe.
Well done, Murray. Here comes the drive to try and drag a few of the Fijian forwards in.
Well, that's the intention. It's to get, at the worst case scenario, to get forward motion ball. He's fought a little bit.
There it is now for Byron Kelleher. Mertens, the pass across to Lomu, sends it on. Intercept again. Mertens is getting back though with Howlett. They're better equipped to handle it this time.
Advantage. Straight in.
Played the advantage. It was against the Fijian tackler who dived in on the ground. Can't do that.
Well, he did it. He definitely did it. He did it to kill the ball, actually. I thought for a moment the penalty was going to go the other way, and I was thinking what an injustice that would be because the Fijian man went dead down on it. So the ball was moved from the drive. That's another pass intercept. I think it was Major again whose pass was intercepted. Howlett down. We didn't quite see it.
It's become a bit of a feature of the game. The Fijians are obviously coming up quickly looking for these opportunities now. They know this is the only way they're really going to score tries. They're going to be very careful and take a bit more depth for running a dummy pass like that.
It's also an ideal opportunity for a missed pass. Chris, if the player is up off his line.
Yes, but the passing's got to be a little quicker.
Yeah.
As the Mexican wave goes around this wonderful stadium, the stadium that generates so much enthusiasm, enjoyment and support. The noise, the volume of the noise. It is a festive occasion. Despite the rain, it has been a spectacle on occasions.
21 minutes to go. As Mayling wins it cleanly again. Major slips it up to Harding. Just out from the 22. Here's McDonnell showing good power. Excellent run by Joe McDonnell. That's the go forward the All Blacks were looking for. Now they burrow in a couple of extra metres and set it nicely for Kelleher. Merton sends it wide to Cullen. And he lobs the pass across to Howlett. And big defence on Doug Howlett.
Huge defence on Doug Howlett.
The All Blacks did everything right there, but the Fijians held them out.
Yes, Doug Howlett. He backed himself and didn't quite make it. Well, Scott Robertson did it all well. Maybe a little pass to the man outside it might have been the case. It was Andrew Mertens. Probably did the right thing. He might have been knocked into touch anyway.
Rasila with the throw. Well claimed by Koyamaboli.
Stay on, stay on.
Rumbaka is the halfback now. Oh, a little under real pressure. About a nice clearance. Well, the TAB gave the Fijians a 61.5-point start. So if you back them, you're doing all right, because at the moment there's only a 26-point difference. And I suggest that you could just about cash up now.
Maybe I'm placing a bet. Bit late, is it?
Bit late. Reuben Thorne, very effective near the front of the lineup.
Once again, the arrow back comes round, in behind. Leave in. The march forward. Yeah, good defence, Fiji. Very good defence.
Offside, though. Referee playing advantage. Mertens sends it on. Here comes Lomu. He's been well marked all night. And no advantage, so back they go.
So the kick for touch and the drive from the line-out, perhaps, I'm sure, New Zealand looking for a try before this game is over.
McDonnell running strongly into it. Lays it back for Kelleher. Now Mertens looking on the inside. It's Harding again. Had a couple of good runs of late.
Hands out.
Kelleher. Fijian swarming in defence. Howlett. Howlett! Supports there from Kelleher. Goal line a couple of metres away. It's been stolen, but the player was offside.
The jersey scored.
Hello, he's reaching in his pocket here, Scott Young. I think this is trouble. And I don't think it's Hankey he wants either.
No, that's not
it. Yeah, it's the yellow. They're going to play with 14 men for the next 10 minutes.
And captain. Right, it's a deliberate infringement. He's offside of the tackle. It's a yellow card, okay? Yeah, no. You have to have one off. Yellow card, okay? Offside. Well, you'll have to... No hooker at all.
Well, he's saying now it's the hooker he's going to go. And, of course, Greg Smith is out of this. So they'll need to bring on another front rower. Otherwise, we'll have, what do they call them? Golden oldies.
See him, mate. Deliberate power. Yeah, definitely. Offside, off the end. Yeah. He came in at the side, clearly.
So Howlett going through. I thought he was going to go all the way. Kelleher went in. Well, the player there with the ball with the jersey being ripped off. The jersey did score, I think, really.
And all these stoppages lost a fair bit of momentum this game. Now this is Rasila, who's a tad reluctant to leave.
I reckon it was a tough call myself, really. I don't think it was necessary either. I mean, admittedly he was offside, he got up and played the ball in offside position, but...
Uncontested scrums for 10 minutes.
Well, it's starting to look a bit like a casualty clearing station. They needed to bring another front row prop on. So it's a golden oldie scrum. Robertson for Kelleher to Lomu. 14 against 15.
Well, he's still on his feet, China.
Now he goes to ground, and the All Blacks will clear it with Mertens to Major. They've defended pretty well this evening. Bracket the line by Mac Donnell.
Roll up it, roll up it.
Mac Donnell probably wants to try too.
Now they go wide. Mertens, little shimmy, fires it wide, and there's the record breaker for Christian Cullen.
Well, it was a classic Andrew Mertens touch. See and do. The see and do double from Andrew Mertens. He saw the situation. It all started with Big Jonah. He went into a two-man tackle. He kept his feet miraculously. I don't know how he did. The All Blacks drove him forward. So the ball was going forward. Mertens got the ball. He saw the first man through. He saw Cullen out, unmarked outside him, totally unmarked. He floated the pass well above, out of danger, no chance of an intercept, and put him away for the record breaker.
Nobody does that better than Andrew Mertens, does he?
Well, this far I can tell you, John Mitchell will want the final whistle shortly, the way things are going. Andrew Mertens copped a high one and a pretty late one as he was offloading there to Christian Cullen. Would you say it was a hospital ward? It's an incredible amount of blood down here.
Must have been very late.
Watch this. Yes. That's not very friendly.
So yes, you're right, Nisbo. It is Justin Marshall on.
But what a sweet moment that was for Christian Cullen. So he passes Jeff Wilson's 44 test tries and he becomes New Zealand's highest test try scorer and the third highest in history as the conversion from Aaron Major goes wide. Only Campo, David Campese with 64 and Rory Underwood with 50 have scored more test tries than this fella.
Well, Jeff Wilson, the record holder, worthy record holder for New Zealand. And now Christian Cullen. Two great names in New Zealand rugby history.
So a moment of history here tonight. And they'll be counting up the players, All Black players on the field shortly. There are that many gone to the bench. So Justin Marshall is on. Ilianau, still a fair way to go in the game. 15 minutes. 49-18.
I see Big Bill still on the field. I'm surprised. I didn't think he was in the last 80 minutes.
Well, I think he has to be honest.
Well, I have got Rawonga on a jersey 18 for the number 8, the Vivarata. He was replaced just before Mertens was injured. I'm just looking at where Justin Marshall's lining up. He looks like he's lining up inside Aaron Major at first 5'8".
I'm sure this is an opportunity Justin would have relished for years.
Well, he's got to throw the ball in. He didn't do a bad job either. Tidied up by Rumbaka. Now Little. Marshall, yes, he's in the thick of things there. Now Little again. Fires it wide to the man who scored two tries, Legere. Down to another man who scored two tries. Here it goes. Opened up almost. Now Harding. Took the tackle right on the halfway line. Now Kelleher. Major. Just settling it all down. Driving the Fijians back with a very good kick. Quickly taken. Now, looking to open it up. Delisar. Nailed on the 22.
Nailed by Maxwell.
And the clearing kick is made. Norm Maxwell.
With intent.
Come here, little man, I've got you.
Yeah. You're not going anywhere, fella.
He doesn't miss too many tackles, Norm. 34th test match tonight. One of the most experienced players in this All Black pack. Tane Randall leading the charge, though, with 48 caps.
Yes. Maxwell doesn't miss too many tackles, and I think the key to that is that he likes tackling. He enjoys tackling. And that's the key not to not missing them.
Mailing has ruled at the back of the line-out for the All Blacks tonight. 11 takes for Simon Malik.
Back around.
Look at Willis in there. He's just looking around for some little holder to get through.
Marshall at first five. Off it goes to Darryl Gibson. Now Reuben Thorne, the captain.
Ruck form.
Marshall.
Yes, I think he's relishing this opportunity, Justin Marshall.
To the man of Bourne.
Anything Major can do, he can do better. Almost a complete replay of the last movement.
Well, it's natural, really, isn't it, for a halfback, particularly one with so much experience, to be able to move out one space. You've just got a little bit more time and a little bit more opportunity, really.
You have. I noticed he had to sort of consciously remember where he's supposed to be. We were in behind the ruck and then had to move back out again.
No, what you said, it's gone.
Line-out infringement by the Fijian, so it's a free kick. All Blacks want a scrum here.
Well, it's a huge blind side with Jonah's side, of course.
No, we've got a prop coming. Number six is going off.
I'd be inclined to
six is going off.
Leave everybody to the right and give the ball to Jonah on the short side and say to the Fijians, well, stop us.
We've got a prop now.
Stop Jonah if you can. One on one, it'll have to be.
That's under the law.
Because
that's
the Fijian backs will have to go wide.
Yeah, I will.
I think we're going to see Jonah, who's inching out towards the open side.
Scrum here, Blackwood.
Outside Marshall, probably, as a runner or a dummy runner.
He's standing over there. He can't come back the short side then because he would be exposed, wouldn't he, on the left hand side?
He would.
Crouch and hold.
He's guaranteed possession here.
Engage. Stay bound.
Robertson. That's offside against Fiji. Playing advantage.
No, knocking it out of the hands.
Well, it was ruled a deliberate knock on.
Knocks here.
So Kelleher takes it. Hands it off to McDonnell, who wants it.
Advantage.
Having gone back to 10 metres, Fiji.
Back on.
So another advantage applies. Case Muse. Now it's Willis. So all three front rowers getting their hands on it. Kelleher now. For Major, lovely pass to Harding.
The advantage is gone now.
Goal line almost there, and the try is scored.
That's all it was.
2-9. Yes, number 5. Norm Maxwell picks up a couple.
Well, he'd be delighted. I thought the debutant was going to score, but he didn't. It was Maxwell. Well, have a look at Harding. He was determined, off his right, beat the tackle, kept going. Well, beautiful covering tackle, actually. Nicky Little, one of them. And then Maxwell was, by Jones, he was in a good body position. He was great, perfectly poised.
This is a nice pass. Look at that. Missed two men. Harding almost makes it. Put there by the pass, and Maxwell, lovely following up. But Nicky Little, you mentioned, Mix, he's played extremely well, hasn't he? He's tackled his heart out. He's kicked well.
Bit of a cheap shot on Andrew Mertens, though.
Well, yeah, everyone's entitled to one, I suppose.
Restart, 10 minutes left. As Tom Willis, he's had a strong game too. McDonnell has come into it in the second half. Kelleher, touched, or Howlett was roaming free down the right wing, and if that had fallen into the arms of Doug Howlett, it might have been another one. Not quite such a good throw that time from Willis. Didn't reach the target, Maxwell. So Fiji have another go in midfield. Some of the big numbers out there now. 20, 22.
Zerak's down side back.
Rambaka in 20 for Little. Now it's Dallasau. Thumped in the tackle.
Zerak's down side.
As Little frees it again. Beautiful runners with the ball, Fijian players, but haven't been given much space. Lomu having to skirt back, has a look to see where Cullen is. Couldn't do much else there.
Well, he set it up intelligently, actually. Of course, not many men have the size and strength to hold up and wait 5 to 10 seconds for the support to arrive, and he could do it.
Aaron Major, lovely step. Here he goes, midfield break. Aaron Major, support's there from Cullen, looking for somebody, and in the end finds Billy, Big Billy, on his way back, covering a bit of ground. And there was a 14. High tackle by one of the All Blacks.
10.
They want to carry on with it. Up to Koya Maiboli.
Well off him.
BG. Tackle missed that time by Maxwell. That is unusual. Barker for Little into midfield. Rambini.
To Ruck. No. On the ground, only at the side.
Well, Maxwell was technically offside, but the ball.
Mark's here.
The ball just squirted out the side of that ball, and Maxwell was there, so he was a victim, really.
To Ruck. High on.
Just over 6.5 minutes to go here. Simon Mailing, almost advantage. An intercept, playing advantage so they can carry on.
Overlap here.
Here's a go. Away goes Jonah. Out of the road, please. Into Cullen, and it's the old combination.
And that's why most people at this stadium think those two players should be in the test team, because they know each other, they sense each other. Extrasensory perception perhaps, but they definitely run off each other. Well, John Lomu, he looks like he's had enough. He gets the ball here, a bit of space. Now have a look at the fend. It's more than a fend. It's get out of here. And then he keeps on going, but he had the intelligence really and the awareness to know that Cullen was on his inside. He offloaded with his left, and for Cullen it was easy. He finished the deal.
It's also timing. Cullen's timing has come back. It's great. I mean, he's just loping along beside Jonah. You can't see him in picture yet. This, it all slows down. It slows down again. And there he is. Suddenly accelerates, and he's away. Lovely to watch.
Three tonight for Christian Cullen. Up he goes to 46 test tries. And the All Blacks starting to motor away now. They have scored 10 tries tonight. So the restart with just 5 minutes left. Brave effort by the Fijians, but they've been outclassed as we expected would happen. Have a look at this for a fend.
Well, a little bit of balancing, Nisbo. That was the fella that made a fool of him at the other end, wasn't it? So I guess you feel a little better about it. Fiji back to the full 15. Big Billy's had enough for the night, been replaced by Bew in jersey 17.
Now Mailing, here's Justin Marshall making a claim for the first 5-8 jersey. Major steps outside the 22 and a very early kick. Not really drawing too many in there. Cullen goes ambling back, useful enough. Well, I guess it's a bit difficult to get a line on this performance, Murray. As I said earlier, they run a bit of a hiding to nothing. The All Blacks are expected to win by plenty, and if they didn't, there'd be huge criticism.
Indeed, but really, it's almost a complete package from this New Zealand team tonight in very difficult conditions.
Yes, we can't underestimate that. It has rained heavily for 24 hours. And the handling has been superb. No problems with the ball. Having said that,
he drops it.
Yeah.
Well, you're right though, Nisbo. They were in the invidious position of coming into this, not able really to get out of here with a win in the public's viewpoint, because they were expected to win by such a big score. But I think they've done that. They've certainly done that in my mind, because they've been so tight, so organised. And they've just finished so well too. It's been, you know, fabulous rugby throughout the game, really. Full on entertainment.
as the technical things that have been done so well, like lineouts.
Still a few minutes left. Maybe some more magic as Major flicks it to Lomu. Here he is again. He's finishing pretty strongly, the big fella. Up to the 22 metres he goes. And it's against the All Blacks, collapsing over the top of it.
Yeah, the ball was killed by a Fijian hand there. Have a look at this on the replay. Well, that's Jonah, in and out. The fend, or the elbow shove off or push off. Running through a tackle. He just keeps his legs pumping in those close quarter confrontational situations. His arms are moving, his legs are moving. That's why he slips out of so many tackles. He never concedes in a tackle. He never says, oh, just take the tackle and fall over. He just wants to get through it.
Not straight, that throw. Referee is going to blow it up. So it's a fairly similar scoreline to the two previous games between these two sides. 74-13 back in 1987, 71-5 in 1997. Now Major whips it wide. It's a bit tough for Case Muse, this one.
Yeah, actually, had Case been running onto the ball, he would have got that.
Yes, Case Muse is running laterally here. It's good. Jonah being brought time and time again into this game.
Nicky Little so often the tackler.
Nicky Little's the only really reliable tackler there.
That's a better throw. Fiji, one last throw of the dice perhaps. Two tries they've produced tonight. Both well taken by Ligiri, the right winger.
Keep on side.
Rambaka. Plenty of willing runners. Richard Nyholt, the loose head prop, is controlling the ball in the final minute or so of this match. Lovely pass. As Keller has to make a tackle.
Well, this is just about the same most phases that Fiji have put together all night. Four.
Well, nearly another intercept. Here's Scott Robertson having a run, but he hasn't got much support. Looking to free the arm up. Now he manages to pop it. And Reuben Thorne, play on, says the referee. Now he might have lost it forward. No, it's still there.
Case Mills wants number three. Ooh, did he get his hand on that? Did he get his hand on that?
16. Number 16.
Coming up for another yellow, I think.
Four, yeah.
He's reaching in the pocket.
Number five.
Not a good sign.
Deliberate, yeah. Up you go. Slowing it down.
Well, he might miss half a minute. That might be it.
Yeah. What are you doing, Rivers?
So they'd have to go for the... Well, obviously they're going to go for a try. It's a matter of... a matter of line out or scrum. So that's the scrum.
Yeah, that's right.
Let's see if they set up this move again. Yes, Jonah's moving out to midfield. So it's the move they're going to do before. And they lost the ball.
They might never go up front yet because it's 8-on-7, Chris.
Stay on.
Wow.
Scott Robinson's got a chance here to get a good old-fashioned pushover try. And he does. You don't see it very often these days. But 8-7 does the trick. And Scott Robertson scores the last try of the match.
How are those TAB odds now, Nisbo?
Yep, Fiji is okay.
Yes, well, it was a great scrum. Admittedly, 8-on-7. One of the easiest tries Scott Robertson's had because the scrum was square. But what's the key? The key to this is he picked up the ball before it reached the goal line to secure it, to make sure it was going to be safe. And then he just dived over. That's exactly what he should do. He's come on, Scott Robinson, as far as efficiency at the back of the scrum in the last year or two.
Siren has gone. Last kick of the game for Aaron Major. And it stays away to the right, but the All Blacks have come up with 11 tries tonight. 11 tries to 2. There are a few casualties out of the game, but Case Mews picked up a couple. Christian Cullen got his fourth hat-trick in Test rugby, and the All Blacks have come through this tonight over Fiji in Wellington by 68-18. For the third time against Fiji, the All Blacks have run in 11 tries in their win tonight here at the WestpacTrust Stadium. Cullen got 3 and became the highest test try scorer in New Zealand history. 2 to Mews, 2 to Maxwell, Major, Howlett, McDonald and Robertson. Nara Major kicked the rest of the points. Norman Laguerre with 2 tries for Fiji. And the All Blacks, after leading 32-6 at half-time, have won 68-18. Let's quickly go under the stand. Smithy is with Reuben Thorne. Not quite with us. Reuben Thorne, the All Black captain. We're just getting him organised. Let's now go under the stand. Ian Smith is with Reuben Thorne.
Yeah, and this one finally caught up with him. Reuben, well, we expected it would be a hard encounter against Fiji, but there'd be some sore bodies and obviously some casualties.
Yeah, there was a few casualties out there, and it's always disappointing to see things like that in the game. You know, there's a few high shots going in and a lot of offside play, I felt, but apart from that, there was also a few good aspects. We scored 68 points, so it wasn't too bad on a difficult night like that.
Yeah, I was just going to say, the 11 tries, so the finishing was very good. The handling, which hasn't been the best in the past, was outstanding in the conditions. Looked like some good driving going too.
Yeah, you know, it was dictated a wee bit by the conditions, but something we'd worked on, and it worked for us a wee bit there.
Also showed up big games from your props again tonight, very evident and open play. Shows the competition on the side, and you know, things are ticking along quite nicely.
Yeah, there's a lot of competition on the side, and you know, those guys tonight, there was another opportunity for them to show their talents, and they did that and played very well.
Okay, a break next week in terms of actual match playing time, but I guess you say the first part of the journey's underway. How are you feeling at this stage with what's coming up?
You know, it's another step tonight, and now we've got a week off to reflect and look at it and try and pick it up for the Tri-Nations, and you know, we're looking forward to that now, and you know, I think things aren't too bad.
Yeah, pretty good effort in the conditions. We'll let you get back and get patched up yourself, eh? Thanks, Ruben.
Cheers, mate. Thanks.
Yeah, it's a week off next week, and the All Blacks open the Tri-Nations against Australia in Christchurch in 2 weeks' time. But a satisfactory effort tonight over Fiji, 68-18. Coming up shortly from Sydney, second test, France against Australia.
Coverage of the All Blacks versus Fiji was proudly brought to you by Telecom New Zealand. In partnership with Ford New Zealand.